97.7 KSAM is KSAM Huntsville, and you're listening to the Bearkats Sports Network. This is the Bearkats Sports Network. It's time for Sam Houston State University Bearcat basketball. 101.7 KSAM has every dribble, swish, and squeak from buzzer to buzzer live. Now let's head down to the floor with the voice of the Bearcats, Rob Hipp.
Well, for the first time since February the 26th, 1977, Texas Longhorns men's basketball is playing inside the historic Gregory Gymnasium. Normally, the side for UT volleyball, the court has been taped for basketball as the Texas Longhorns host the Sam Houston Bearcats. 44 years have passed since the Horns men's basketball team last played in this facility. And that time, they hosted Baylor for the first round of the Southwest Conference Tournament. Tonight, though, it's student only in an electric atmosphere here off the campus of the University of Texas in Austin, Texas, as the now seventh-ranked Longhorns seek to continue their domination over the Bearcats. A very good and pleasant, wonderful evening. I'm Rob Hipp, and thanks for joining us here in the booth and also on the Bearcats Sports Radio Network. Well, as I mentioned earlier, Sam Houston on the road here versus seventh-ranked Texas. Texas leads this series 15 games to 2 all-time. In the last meeting, it was a year ago at the Irwin Center, actually on December the 16th, as the Bearcats held tough with Texas, but eventually fell in that contest 79-63. Well, I mentioned earlier back at the Greg here, Texas playing its first actual game inside this facility. You got to go all the way to that Baylor game, February the 26th of 1977. Several players that we'll keep an eye out in this ball game for Texas. You'll hear from them from head coach Jason Hooten a little bit later, but a 6'3" senior guard, Courtney Ramey, as he topped 1,000 points, the senior became the 40th player in the Longhorn program history to reach that 1,000-point milestone in Wednesday's victory over California Baptist. He has registered 1,002 points in 99 career games heading in here to the Greg tonight. For now, though, we'll step aside. We'll take a brief break. I had a chance to catch up with head coach Jason Hooten. Pre-game continues. Stay with us, friends. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Sam Houston Athletics would like to thank the following partners: Charlie's Used Cars, Domino's Pizza, Haven at M, Dr. Walt Lowe, Smoothie King, and Mike's Hard Lemonade. Thank you for supporting your Bearcats.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Rob Hipp here, pregame with Sam Houston men's basketball head coach Jason Hooten, as today the Bearcats on the road facing Texas. But before we talk about that one, looking back previously in that previous game versus SMU, Sam Houston almost overcame a 24-point deficit in the second half, a 75-66 loss at the Moody Center. Coach, just kind of your thoughts on that game. It seems like the team is constantly improving with each game.
I sure hope so. It feels like it, but you know, I think until you get some results or see some results, which usually come with wins, it doesn't make you feel any better. I do think that game was a tale of two halves. I mean, they shot the cover off of it in the first half, and you know, it was part of our game plan. You know, we did a good job of taking the threes away from the guys that had been making them, but they had a couple of guys on their team that hadn't made them all year long, and they made, you know, one was 3-for-3 in the first half, and that's just part of basketball, and that's the way it goes sometimes. I was proud of the way we fought back and, you know, cut it to 6 with 2 minutes to go and, you know, had the ball and an opportunity to make it a one-possession game, and it just wasn't our night. So, you know, all in all, I do think that we took a step forward and that we, you know, saw some improvement in a lot of areas.
We talked last year about Tristan Igbe, and you said he may be one of the best rebounders that you've had as a Sam Houston Bearcat. He had 13 boards in that game. How impressed have you been with his play and just how he's matured with this program?
Yeah, I mean, Tristan's just a guy you can lean on and count on, and you know what you're going to get from him. He's an effort guy, you know, night in and night out. He's an everyday guy. You know, he's really improved his offense, and, you know, we as a staff have kind of made it a point that we feel like he needs to average double figures for our team to be successful. And I think right around 5, 6, 7 a game right now. So he's got a little room to go there and a little work to do. But the rebounding and the defense and the effort and those things are all constants for him. I think the biggest thing in the bigger picture for us is just seeing him being a, you know, 10-point a game guy for us. And, you know, that's important when you look at, you know, another 3 or 4 points a game from him alone. You know, now all of a sudden that gets our average up around, you know, 74. And, you know, I think there's still a few guys out there that aren't scoring at the rate that they're going to and making shots like they will. And I think eventually we'll get back around 78, 80 a game.
Tonight, facing the 8th-ranked Longhorns on the road at Austin, not at the Irwin Center this year. It's the first time the Horns have played men's basketball in Gregory Gymnasium since 1977. It's going to be a unique atmosphere, students only allowed in here. There will be some parents, but majority of it's going to be students. Just kind of your thoughts heading into this. You came in a day early, got some practice in. Just let us know your thoughts heading into this one.
Well, it's a neat opportunity. I think that, you know, you take a step back and you look at, you know, what this means to our guys, and something that they'll always remember. I think the coach in me is like, it's just another game, and I'm just concerned with how we're going to play, and, you know, we're going to try to go win a basketball game is really my concern right now. But it is a neat venue for sure. It's a place that I've been in. Luckily, you know, being the guy from Texas and Central Texas, I've been in this gym before, but it's a neat deal. And I was with Coach Beery today right after their shoot around, right before ours, and you know, back in the day when they played here, they would write the scores of the game when it was over on the steps that go up to the bleachers. And there was a score there from when they had played Sam Houston, you know, back then. And just neat stuff like that, history-wise, I think is really cool for, you know, for our guys to always, again, have something to remember.
Now it's time for Coach Hooten's Keys to the Game, presented by Emblem Properties Real Estate. Coach, your keys to victory in this one tonight?
Well, there's a bunch when you're going to try to beat the number 8 team in the country, for sure. I think the number one thing that we have to do is, you know, we got to take away their transition and easy baskets. We got to try to make it as hard as we can for them to score tonight, and, you know, to make them run their offense in a half court. And, you know, I think when you're playing a bigger and, you know, a really talented team like this, you know, you've got to do a really good job of making them shoot threes, contested, and not letting them post up on you and get it inside. And, you know, we call it getting to the paint and getting downhill. And I think there's probably two more that I would put in there tonight, Rob. And one is that we got to rebound the ball. You know, they're big and strong and athletic, and we're going to have to do a good job of blocking out and gang rebounding. And then the last one, which may be the most important one, and maybe one that I'm really looking forward to seeing tonight, is we got to take care of the ball. You know, we've gone 3 straight games where we've had less than 10 turnovers, and that's really, really hard to do in the game of basketball. So I've been very pleased with that, and tonight will be a true test of that because their defense is so good, and they're so long and athletic, and they really switch and cheat and get in passing lanes. And so we're gonna get tested. You know, if we can come out of this thing tonight with 8 or 9 rebounds, we're going to have a great opportunity to win a basketball game.
The Keys to the Game brought to you by Emblem Properties Real Estate, who offers the customer service difference where our clients are number one. Coach, as always, appreciate your time. Good luck tonight, and eat them up, Cats.
Thanks, Rob. Eat them up, Cats.
This wraps up our pregame with head coach Jason Hooten. More pregame coming up when we come back from Van Wagner. This is Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Ticketmaster is glad we are back holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at TicketSmarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on TicketSmarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. TicketSmarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. TicketSmarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
It's about what real estate agents enjoy the most. It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, Cats!
Welcome back, friends. Rob Hipp live from the broadcast booth here on the Bearkats Sports Radio Network as Texas, the University of Austin, University of Texas at Austin, hosting your Sam Houston Bearkats here tonight. I talked a little bit earlier about this series. Texas leads at 15-2. You got to go all the way back of the 79-63 loss. It was December the 16th, 2020 at the Irwin Center. But this Sam Houston Bearcat team, new players and the UT with a lot of transfers and playing here for the first time in 44 years at Gregory Gymnasium. It is loud. The students are on their feet. The band is right in front of us, and we are set for a fun, exciting college basketball game here tonight. For Texas, a defensive identity during its current three-game winning streak, the Longhorns have held their opponents to 46 points a game on a combined 38.3% field from the shooting at 51-133, including a 28.8% mark, 17-59 from three-point range. UT has forced 70 turnovers and posted a 75-23 margin in points off turnovers. We heard from Coach Hooten. I was also in several of the video viewings during before this one, of course, and just talking to Coach, and he said, look, we've just got to continue to hold on to the ball and not turn it over, especially live ball turnovers. Sam Houston has done a great job through that so far this season. They had under 10 in the previous game versus SMU, and we'll see if they can continue to build on what they have. Sam Houston, of course, only 2-4 this season, but a team that is learning, a team that is growing. The culture is starting to develop, and we'll see if Sam Houston can hold tough here tonight with 7th-ranked Longhorns. Well, this marks UT's first men's contest in Gregory Gym since the Longhorns played Baylor back in 1977. This Texas-Sam Houston game will mark the first regular season men's basketball game played inside Gregory since a 90-51 Texas victory against Rice on February the 22nd of 1977. This facility started in 1930, hosting basketball games, went 40 for many years, all the way to 1977. Of course, then the Irwin Center was built. That in the process of its final year as the Moody Center being built for Texas, a very nice facility right near their soccer fields. It's going to be a nice one here for Austin and for the University of Texas. Frank Irwin Center, again, you go back to 1977-78 when things got started, but here tonight should be a fun one as the Longhorns earned a 34-33 victory against North Texas on December the 5th, 1930. That was the first matchup in this facility. Over that span of 47 years, Texas compiling an overall record of 383 wins and 160 losses here in this contest. I mentioned earlier, this is for the students tonight. The University of Texas not selling and distributing tickets for this game as tonight's contest, a UT student-only attendance. Now, there are some players here or some players' parents here that were granted tickets, but other than that, it is full of UT burnt orange tonight here at Gregory Gymnasium. The first 2,000 students, they received a Texas basketball retro shirt. They also got some free barbecue. But we are moments away, about 5 minutes until starting lineups and more. For now, though, we'll step aside and take a break. Stay with us, friends. This is Sam Houston men's basketball on the Bearkats Sports Radio Network.
Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. Busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Package Hangers Mall. They ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Package Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Package Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Package Ship.
Ticket Smart is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater event, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Back at it, friends. Rob Hipp here on a Monday night in the capital of Texas in Austin. Thanks for joining us for Sam Houston men's basketball. Quickly looking back, the Bearcats last playing on Wednesday right before Thanksgiving was a loss on the road at SMU 75-66 on Wednesday. Mark, the Bearcats' second loss in a row. Sam Houston, though, they almost overcame a 24-point deficit in that second half in the 75-66 loss at Moody Center on the road. The Bearcats got as close as 6 points in the final few minutes, but they ran out of time in the end to fall 2-4 on the season. The Texas A&M graduate transfer, Savion Flagg, led Sam Houston in that contest with 21 points and 11 rebounds, had a double-double, his second one of the season, and then DeMarcus light him up Lampley, hit some key shots in that second half to finish with 16. Jaron Cook and also Jaden Ray getting into the action with 8 points in that contest. Tristan Ipe, by the way, he just missed a double-double, 7 points and 13 rebounds, as the Bearcats continuing to dominate on the boards this early season, 45-39 in that previous contest. The Cats cut that 24-point deficit to 16 when Lampley drove to the basket, had a layup and got fouled. He hit the free throw for the three-point play to make it 55-39. Sam Houston continuing through that contest. They had a 7-0 run on another three-point play, this time from Savion Flagg, 60-46 halfway through the period. But SMU finally ended that scoring drought with a free throw, and that's how that story went on the previous game last Wednesday. For the Texas Longhorns, their last game, a victory. By the way, seventh ranked as the new polls came out earlier today. That victory versus California Baptist. It was at the Irwin Center here in Austin, a 68-44 victory in that contest. Seniors Timmy Allen and Andrew Jones, they both had 15 points to lead Texas, now 4-1 on the season, to a 68-44 victory against California Baptist, who entered that contest at 5-1 on Wednesday evening. That was at the Irwin Center. It marked the third and final home game as part of the Abe Limits Classic. It's a multi-team event honoring the legacy of the former basketball coach. Senior Courtney Ramey for the Longhorns, he had 12 points to become the 40th player in program history to reach that 1,000-point milestone. We talked about that earlier, entering tonight's contest, 1,002 points in his career in 99 games. For the Longhorns, limited CBU in that contest to 44 points, 41% from the field, 17-42, including 12.5 from three-point range on the evening. UT allowed just 6 assists. They forced 23 turnovers and registered a 25-11 advantage in points off of those turnovers. So tonight, it's going to be a story of holding on to the ball for Sam Houston, also trying to keep up with the rebounding, and look for the fast breaks here from this University of Texas team. They are very fast, a lot of speed, and a very seasoned veteran team. For now, though, we'll step aside. We'll take another break. When we come back, we'll have starting lineups and tip-off moments away from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, Cats!
Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards, to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. Busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
Welcome back, friends, and a very pleasant good evening from Austin, Texas. We'll quickly go over the Texas Longhorns starting lineup tonight. We'll start with a 6'6", 210-pound senior forward out of Mesa, Arizona, the transfer from Utah. It's number 0, Timmy Allen. By the way, Allen averaging 14 points a game, leading the Longhorns in 5 games this season. A 6 foot 290-pound senior guard out of Toronto, Ontario, Canada. The transfer from Minnesota, number 2, Marcus Carr. At guard, a 6 foot 385-pound senior from St. Louis, Missouri. And also the transfer from Webster Groves, it's number 3, Courtney Ramey, who's 7-for-7 from the free throw line this young season. At guard, a 6'5", 190-pound senior out of Houston, Texas, and Westfield, number 13, Jace Bebras. And last but certainly not least, a 6'9", 220-pound junior out of Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, UMass, number 33, Trey Mitchell. Again, it is Allen, Carr, Ramey, Bebras, and Mitchell for the Texas Longhorns. And here is your Sam Houston Bearcats starting lineup for tonight. Turnaround jumper here, Tristan Igbe starting early, and the Bearcats take a 2-point advantage. Find Lampley from the corner, weaving through traffic, the jumper, the 2-shot, the yes, there it is, to Marcus Lampley for 2, turn on the light. Over to Jaron Cook for 3, light the stove, baby, it's Jaron Cook, and the Bearcats are on fire here in the first half. He pulls it back down, though. Oh, what a play by Javion May as he hauled in aggressively the offensive rebound and dropped it back in off the right side of the glass. Dante Power, zing, zang, bang, there it is for 2. Oh, call dancing with the stars. We got a new celebrity on the court. It's Dante Powers. He's saying, I can dance just as good as you guys on TV. I do it on the basketball court.
At guard, a 6'7", 215-pound grad senior from Texas A&M University, number 1, Savion Flagg.
At guard, a 6'2", 195-pound junior from Chicago, Illinois, number 11, I'm Javion May.
At forward, a 6'6", 225-pound senior from Deer Park, Texas, number 12, I'm Tristan Igbe.
At guard, a 5'10", 165-pound junior from Midwest City, Oklahoma, number 13, I'm Jaden Ray.
At guard, a 6'2", 175-pound senior from Phenix City, Alabama, number 3, I'm Light 'Em Up, DeMarcus.
So once again, for your Sam Houston Bearcats, it's Savion Flagg, DeMarcus Lampley, Javion May, Tristan Igbe, and Jaden Ray. The Sam Houston Bearcats out of the Western Athletic Conference the first year at 2-4 this season under head coach Jason Hooten. The 1993 Tarleton State alum, his 12th season at Sam Houston, 218 victories, 151 losses. And for the Texas Longhorns of the Big 12 Conference, 4-1, their lone loss coming to Gonzaga this season as they are ranked number 7 in the nation under head coach Chris Beard, a Texas alum from 1995, his first year at Texas at 4-1, previously at Texas Tech for 5 years, 112 wins, 55 losses, in his 10th overall season, 212 victories and 86 losses. It is loud here at the Greg. Sam Houston in their black jerseys, black shorts, Bearcat orange numbers in white outlined, or in orange outlined in white. And the opening tip-off is controlled by the Longhorns. And here we go on a Monday night from Gregory Gymnasium. As the Horns control the opening tip-off, they'll move from right to left in their white jerseys and white pants, burnt orange Longhorn numbers, and the name Longhorns in cursive on the top. And we've got a timeout forced immediately here. Javion May on the far side forcing a timeout with excellent defense. Again, as we're just underway, 19:45 to go here in the first half. Want to welcome you into the broadcast booth. If you're also listening tonight on the Bearcat Sports Radio Network, feel free to text us on that Bearcat fan text line at 512-522-9105. Again, that Bearcat fan text line is open tonight, 512-522-9105. Data messaging rates may apply, and please don't text and drive. This game tonight made possible in part by our good friends at H-E-B. H-E-B, no store does more than my H-E-B. As we'll get back into play here on the far side, again, UT in their white jerseys, white shorts, actually more of a cream color, kind of throwing it back here in honor of Gregory Gymnasium. The names written across the back in burnt orange as well. The numbers, Longhorns in cursive on the front. The Nike swoosh logo is on the right shoulder. Inbounding here is Timmy Allen. 90 career games, 87 starts. 4 years here for that young man. And here come the Longhorns as they'll inbound. Over to the left side, Carr, now right wing three. Courtney Ramey nails it. Got to watch him. 5 of 13, 38% on this season, and he comes out early with a three-pointer here, and the Longhorns take the early advantage. Savion Flagg to DeMarcus Lampley. On the right wing, he is guarded by Marcus Carr. Over to Igbe. It's loud here from the students tonight. Pass down low, Flagg trying to gut it off the left side. Good for Savion Flagg. It was a good feed down low on the left side, and Flagg able to lay it up off the left side of the glass. And the Longhorns leading 3-2, 1 minute gone here in the first half. Bringing into the front court is Timmy Allen. Allen goes over to the wing to Ramey on the left side. And Javion May pokes it around, and it goes out of bounds off the Bearcats. It will stay with the Horns with 16 on the shot clock. Tonight's officials, the crew chief, John Higgins, referee James Breeding, and the second referee, Kelly Self. As we're back in action here, the Horns have it on the left side. Carr near the near side, working a right-handed dribble on Jaden Ray. Crossing over from the elbow, flips this one up, and the ball bounces around, doesn't fall in, and the Cats with the rebound. Goes to Ipe, now back to Jaden Ray. Ray has it on the near side, moving from left to right, crossing the timeline, left-handed dribble. He is guarded up top by the Horns' Marcus Carr, the 6'1" senior guard. Ray with it, 15 on the shot clock, plenty of time. He'll rotate over right wing. Here's line him up Lampley from downtown off the front of the rim. It won't fall, but Javion May with the position has the rebound, and now it's Jaden Ray, white ring three, bam, Jaden Ray. And Sam Houston has an early advantage, 5-3, 18-14 to go here in the first half. Horns quickly back in transition to the left side. Mitchell has it. Some from the semicircle, and it's turned over. Javion May has it. Up top to Lampley. Lampley left side, rolls out, won't fall. The ball poked around, and it goes out of bounds off of the Longhorns, and the Bearcats will have it right back here, holding on to a two-point advantage, 5-3. 2 minutes gone here in the first. As Jaden Ray will inbound on the right baseline under his own rim, up top to Savion Flagg from the right wing. Left-handed dribble, works inside from the left side, trying to penetrate. Now pass over his head, finds Javion May for three, rattles in, good, and the Bearcats hot early here from downtown, leading 8-3, 17:45 to go. It's an early advantage for the visiting Sam Houston Bearcats. As Timmy Allen will bring it into the front court, he is guarded up top by Savion Flagg. Right-handed dribble, controlling it here, trying to set up the offense. Bounce pass goes to Carr on the left wing. He is double-teamed. Carr over the head, pass goes down low to Trey Mitchell. Mitchell to the right wing, here's a three. This one an air ball by Courtney Ramey. Out of bounds, and they're gonna say it went off of the Bearcats. So the Sam Houston showing some pesky defense here, forcing turnovers. And we've got a substitution on the court as Jace Febres checks out for the first time in this ball game. And Marcus Carr set to inbound here on the left side. Again, it's 8-3, Sam Houston by five. The officials taking a little bit of time here as Coach Hooten looks over, trying to figure out what's going on. And they will whistle us back into play here in just a few moments as the official gonna take a look and see maybe if that ball went out of bounds off of Sam Houston. Not sure here in front of us. They may be looking at a review here to see where it went out of bounds off of. We'll step aside. We'll take 30 seconds. Bearcats leading early 8-3, 17:24 to go here in the first half. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime One burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
Back at it here, Texas retains possession after they look at it. It was the Longhorns' ball. The ball poked out of bounds, though, and it will remain again with UT as Carr set to inbound here. His team trailing 8-3 with almost 3 minutes gone here in the first half. Carr will go over to the left elbow into the hands of Timmy Allen. He is guarded by Flagg. Allen, quick chest pass goes to Ramey. Right side, had position on Ipe and laid it up easily off the right side of the glass going from the baseline. 8-5, Sam Houston up front. Jaden Ray has it on the right side to the right wing. Finds Javion May, now up top, Ipe. He'll pick up his dribble. The ball in his left hand being swatted out. Now the pass over to Savion Flagg. Flagg driving inside, right side, slice and dice. Lays it up off the right side of the glass. The Bearcats leading by 5, 10-5. 16:44 to go here in the first half of play. As the Horns will bring it back over to the right side. Carr has it, good defense here by Jaden Ray. Ball up top into the hands of Allen. Allen takes a long jumper with Savion Flagg in his face. The shot's no good. And the rebound ping-ponged around, and Jaden Ray has it in the backcourt. As he'll glance over his right shoulder to head coach Jason Hooten. Hooten directing his players. Ray now into the front court on the near side here, moving from left to right. Ray tries to penetrate inside, loses the handle, and the Horns have it. Here comes Allen over to Ramey. Bounce pass back over, and an easy layup on the assist by Allen there off the right side of the glass. So the Bearcats turn it over. That leads to two quick points in transition for the Horns. 10-7, Sam Houston by three. 4 minutes gone here, 16 on the clock in the first half. as Jaden Ray has it on the right side. Just under the right horn of the Longhorns logo at center court as he has taken his time. He is guarded up top by Andrew Jones. Here's Jaden Ray to the right side. Tried to put it up around the left, and that shot nowhere close as Trey Mitchell may have got a block on it. Here come the horns now on the near side from right to left as Ramey brings it into the front court. Bearcats hold that two, double team up top over to Allen. Now the ball back in the hands of Mitchell. Chest pass goes up top to Ramey, right wing. Back over to Andrew Jones. He'll float this one up from the baseline, and easy does it for the sixth season with UT, Andrew Jones. Jones, of course, an inspirational story. The young man diagnosed with leukemia back in 2018, a successful treatment at MD Anderson. And he has been a heart and soul here for this Longhorns team. His last treatment was in 2019, and he's playing strong here for the Horns. Bearcats have it back on the right side. Over to Jaden Ray on the left wing. He is guarded by Carr. Back up top, Lampley. Lampley driving inside, tries to float one around, and it's stripped, and the ball bouncing around. Hooten wanting a travel call, and we'll see here if it does. I believe it may go to back to Sam Houston. But that'll take us to our first media timeout. Bearcats holding tough here, leading by one, 10-9, 14, 54 to go in the first half. We'll step aside for 2 minutes. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus network, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
For the best customer service and best deal on your new Ford, head to Bill Fick Ford in Huntsville, your Noble headquarters. Thinking something sporty and great on gas? Check out the 2022 Ford Explorers and Expeditions. Don't see what you want on the lot? You can still get a Noble deal on a special order with the assistance of your sales associate, or just go to BillFickFord.com. Click order here and design your new Ford today. Built for you, by you. Bill Fick Ford, I-45 South in Huntsville.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Welcome back, friends. Rob Hipp live from Austin, Texas at Gregory Gymnasium. Thanks for joining us. Sam Houston leading the seventh-ranked Horns 10-9, 14:54 to go here in the first half. As Sam Houston should have it here in just a few moments. Andrew Jones turned it over before we went to that media timeout. Sam Houston so far in this ballgame, great job shooting. 4 of 7 from the field, 57%. It's been 2 of 3 from downtown, though, for the Bearcats. Getting into the action earlier from three-point land with Javion May and Jaden Ray. Bearcats are going to have to keep up with this high-tempo, fast-paced Longhorn offense tonight to have a chance in this one. So far, though, they look very strong coming out here early. And an unbelievable electric atmosphere, as I described it earlier. A lot of students here. It is a student-only contest tonight. And talking with some of the folks here at UT, they said that they're going to be doing this about once a year or so. It's the final year of the Irwin Center. But a great way just to kind of bring back a – I described it to colleague Craig Way, who's on the radio call for the Longhorns. It's kind of like a real high-energy high school game tonight, but it's got the college flavor to it. And you can't go wrong when you got two teams from the state of Texas battling it out here tonight. As we'll get back into action, Javion May will inbound just in front of the scorer's table on his own side on the right side. May goes up top to Dante Powers. Powers checking in just moments ago. The 6'2" junior guard has it on the left wing. High screen, Savion Flagg. Dante holds onto it now to the right wing. It's Flagg. Flagg trying to fend off his defender. Shaking and baking his way down, and he gets a strip. Poking it away is Ramey, and here come the Horns. They'll slow things down, though, for the moment. Jones has it back on his side on the left. Swing pass goes up top to Allen, guarded by Powers. Allen waiting, trying to find an open player, waiting on a play to develop from the left elbow. He'll find Bishop, left wing three. This one good for Bishop. Boy, Bishop just drained it there. Christian Bishop, the 6'7" senior forward, with his second three-pointer of the season. He was 1-for-3 on the season before that one just moments ago. Hipp has it up top for the Bearcats. As he'll swing around the defender, Bishop, spinning his way inside the paint, flip it up. This one off the back of the glass. Good for Tristan Hipp. A fancy footwork there for Hipp, and we are tied at 12 apiece as Kuba Kowalski set to check in here in just a few moments. Ramey has it for the Horns on the near side to the left. Bounce pass goes over to Allen. Allen guarded by Flagg, trying to work from the right elbow. Now drops his pass over, has it back over the right wing. This one into the backcourt, and the Horns turn it over. Great defense again by Sam Houston, forcing another turnover by the Longhorns. So far in this one, three turnovers for Sam Houston and three for Texas as well. Kuba Kowalski will check in, and Tristan Hipp over to the bench. It is Kowalski Powers on the court for Sam Houston, alongside Savion Flagg and DeMarcus Lampley. The inbound by Javion May to Dante Powers on the right side. Powers with a right-handed dribble, looking over his right shoulder, now puts the ball on the court to the right wing. Drop pass over to Javion May, trying to split through two defenders. May floats this one up, good for Javion May. Nice footwork by May as he was patient, floated it up, and the Bearcats have the lead again, 14-12, 13-23 to go here in the first half. Bishop has it over on the left wing. Quick right-handed pass right into the hands of Marcus Carr at the top. Carr works his dribble, now picks it up from the left elbow. Back over to Jones. Jones has it, back up top to Carr on the left wing for three with a partial hand in his face, but the rebound goes to Mitchell. The Horns have it here with 19 on the shot clock. Trying to work down low is Jones, and he'll find a wide open Carr. This one off the front of the rim won't drop, and the rebound by Kuba Kowalski. Here come the Bearcats from left to right. Flagg has it in the right hand as he is guarded by Brock Cunningham. Flagg, quick pass over to Kowalski at the top from the left wing. Still has it, spinning around. Drops the pass over to DeMarcus Lampley. Swings over now to Dante Powers, just below the Big 12 logo. Over to Flagg from the right corner. 10 on the clock. Flagg baseline, blocked from behind by Bishop, and here come the Horns. From right to left, behind the back, Carr has it quickly into the front court. Guarded by Javion May, picks it up on the baseline, up top to Jones. Jones guarded by Lampley, puts his right hand on his head to call a play, and now working off a high screen from Bishop. He'll sling this one over to the right corner. It is Marcus Carr. He traveled, and the Bearcats have forced another turnover, and they'll have it right back here, leading by two, 14-12, 12-17 to go in the first half. Inbounding on the opposite end of the court, Sam Houston, shooting 6 of 10 from the field at 67%, 2 of 3 from that three-point land. They've only turned it over three times. They've scored 5 points off of four Texas turnovers. As Dante Powers now has it into the front court, crossover dribble, drops the pass over to Savion Flagg with a right-handed dribble. He is guarded by Cunningham. Flagg rotates over near the right wing, trying to put on a move here. Kicks this one over Lampley, right corner three. This one off the back of the iron, that's his shot. Kowalski trying to fight for the rebound, and it goes out of bounds off of Kowalski. Devin Askew was down there, it bounced off of him. And that will take us to a media timeout. Substitutions coming up as the Bearcats leading 14-12. The Longhorns have it when we come back in 2 minutes from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
At H-E-B, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of H-E-B jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an H-E-B Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit H-E-B, your official game day headquarters, or use the My H-E-B app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. Busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
Back at it, friends. Thanks for joining us. Sam Houston men's basketball on the road tonight in the capital city of Texas in Austin, leading 14-12, 11:52 to go at the Longhorns on a 2-minute, 33-second scoring drought. Sam Houston so far shooting 6 of 11 at 55%, 2 of 4 from downtown. The Bearkats and the Horns have both turned it over five times. Sam Houston leading the battle in the paint, 8-4. They've had 6 second chance points. And Texas, though, holding on here with 5 turnovers, 4 down in the paint, 2 second chance points, 2 fast breaks, and 5 off the bench. As we get back into action after the media timeout, Damon Nicholas Jr. checking in moments ago alongside Jaron Cook. So on the court for the Bearkats, it is Cook, Nicholas, Dante Powers, Kowalski, and Savion Flagg, who is getting talked to in the right ear from head coach Jason Hooten. That'll whistle us back into action here, as the Horns will have it coming out of this media timeout. Again, UT has not scored in over 2.5 minutes. Sam Houston playing aggressive here early. We'll see if they can hold on to this momentum. Cooper Kowalski is a tall force out there for this Bearcat team, standing tall at 7'2", going up against the 7th-ranked Longhorns here in the nation. As the inbound pass from Cunningham will go in the backcourt over to Ramey, who's leading all scores right now for the Horns with 5 so far. Ramey has it on the left wing, guarded by Nicholas, who checked in just moments ago. Cunningham over the right wing, chest pass to Jones. Jones back up top into the hands of Marcus Carr, guarded by Nicholas. Carr wanting to work inside the paint. Good job by the Bearcats here, not allowing much down low. As 7 on the shot clock, trying to work here is Ramey, guarded by Dante Powers, backpedaling, turnaround jumper, good. Boy, beautiful footwork there by Ramey. That left line able to drop it in on a jump shot. It's 14-14. We are tied again here in Austin. As Dante Powers has it on the left wing. Goes over to Jaron Cook, who's a force from three-point land. He'll take one here. Jaron Cook, this one off the left side of the rim. And the flying in rebound by Ramey as he skyrocketed over players. Horns back the other way. Cunningham on the left wing trying to work inside on Cook. The pass goes to Ramey. Ramey holding it near his hip. Now the chest pass goes over into the hands of Bishop, working left baseline through a defender. Powers thought he was about to have a block, and now there is a block from behind, but a foul called here against Sam Houston on Bishop. We'll see if that's on Savion Flagg. A foul there by Sam Houston. It's actually called on Kubra Kowalski. That is his first personal and the second team foul by Sam Houston. Again, we are tied 14 apiece, 10:46 to go here in the first half of play. And Brock Cunningham at the line here to shoot 2 for the Horns. 7 of 8 this season, an 88% free throw shooter. Leading the team, takes a few bounces, bends his knees, right-handed free throw on its way, and good. The 6'6" junior forward makes the first one, and the Horns regain the lead 15-14. Substitutions on the court here for the Longhorns as Chase Febbers checking back into the ball game. And here's the second free throw by Cunningham on its way. Makes both of them. So Tristan Ipe will check back in for Kuba Krawowski. As Sam Houston trailing here by 2, 16-14, 10:46 to go here in the first half. Savion Flagg will inbound on the opposite baseline. Pass goes up top to Dante Powers. Trying to get trapped in the backcourt. Carr's back there with it. He's got to get it across and finally does to Ipe. Great heads-up play. Here's Ipe inside the paint, throws it over to the right corner, and it's out of bounds. Ipe was trying to do a little too much there, got trapped and threw it away, and it's a turnover by Sam Houston. Ipe will take his right hand and clap it on the 12 of his chest, saying, my bad, guys. 16-14, Texas up front, 10:28 to go here in the first half. The Horns have it back on the left side. It's Courtney Ramey over the left wing. Carr over the head pass goes down low to Mitchell. Mitchell trying to work on Ipe. He's trapped. Passes over. Carr for three. Yes, from the left wing.
Marcus Carr.
Carr buries that one, 19-14. Bearcats trailing by five. The largest lead for UT here in this game. Savion Flagg will bring it into the front court. Left-handed dribble, high screen, Ipe. Flagg trying to work through it. Down low, floats this one over to Ipe down in the paint. Off the left side, no good. But the putback good by Savion Flagg. So Savion Flagg stayed with it, and he's rewarded with 2 points for his team. 19-16, three-point Horn advantage, 9:44 to go. Here's a right two-point jumper. That shot is good for Carr. 21-16, Bearcats trailing by five. As Savion Flagg has it on the near side, right-handed dribble. Threatening him on the defense is Timmy Allen. Flagg, though, trying to work through two. Over to the right wing, up top to Ipe, left-handed dribble. Trying to rotate over to the left wing, picks up his dribble. The pass goes to Dante Powers. Powers, bounce pass to Ipe. Back over to Savion Flagg from the free throw line. Inside the paint, swoop, hoop, and good, and one for Savion Flagg. The Bearcats showing some life again here in the first. So Marcus Carr with his first personal, it's the first team foul. And an and-one opportunity coming up here for Sam Houston's Savion Flagg. He's only 10 of 26 from the charity stripe this season, a 38% free throw shooter. He has got to improve as the season goes on. Most pressure that he's faced here this season, the free throw on its way, doesn't make that one, and the rebound by Mitchell. Here come the Longhorns on the far side from right to left. Courtney Ramey guarded by Javion May, crossing the Horns logo at the timeline. Bounce pass over to the right wing to Carr. Carr goes over the top, down low to Mitchell. Mitchell back up top. Around the world we go to Febris. He will find Timmy Allen down on the baseline with Flagg guarding him, 10 on the shot clock. He'll spin around inside off the right side. Shot's not there, but a foul called here on Savion Flagg. And for Flagg, that is his first personal and the third team foul. That will send the Longhorns to the line here, shooting two.
On the line, shooting two, Timmy Allen.
It is Timmy Allen, the 6'6" senior, a 70% free throw shooter entering this contest at 14 of 20 in five games. He'll bend his knees, the right-handed free throw, delivery on its way and good at the bottom of the net. 22-18, Longhorns, 8:50 to go here in the first. On the court for the Horns, it is Allen, Carr, Ramey, Feberson, Mitchell, and for your Bearcats, Flagg, Cook, May, Ipe, and Ray. As Allen will take a deep breath, bends his knees, here's the free throw. This one, yes, both of them good. 23-18. Largest lead tied back for the Horns as it's getting loud again here in the Greg. The Cats advance it into the front court. Jaden Ray has it standing near the half court circle. They've got it taped off tonight here for basketball. The clock winding down, 10 on the shot clock here for Ray. Now tries to take it inside, left wing, up top, Jaron Cook from downtown, bounces off the front of the rim, the rebound, Javion May. He'll put it up, shot's blocked, and it goes into the hands of the Horns. Here comes Timmy Allen, over to the near side now, Ramey from right to left. Savion Flagg guarding him, Ramey up top. Right-handed dribble, bounce pass goes down low to Mitchell. Mitchell from way out there on the left elbow. That shot won't fall. The rebound, Savion Flagg. The Horns have made six of their last eight shots before that miss just moments ago. And here comes Sam Houston's Jaden Ray on the right wing. With a right-handed dribble, crosses it over to his left hand and almost turned it over, but able to hold on to it. Down low to Ipe. Ipe is trapped by two, trying to fend off the defender. As he works inside on Carr, throws this one up. Shot's not there, partially blocked, and Ramey hauls it in. And now the Horns moving quickly from right to left. Carr has it from the right elbow. He'll go baseline, and a foul here on Timmy Allen. And he may have sold that one a little bit extra on the play, to be honest. Student fans here not happy. The foul is on Tristan Ipe, his second personal and the fourth team foul. That'll take us to a timeout. The officials are going to go and review this one to see if it's a flagrant. I know Ipe well, and he does not get frustrated and commit those kind of penalties on purpose. He was just playing hard defense down there. We'll go ahead and step aside. We will take a 60-second timeout from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
For the best customer service and best deal on your new Ford, head to Bill Fick Ford in Huntsville, your No Bull headquarters. Thinking something sporty and great on gas? Check out the 2022 Ford Explorers and Expeditions. Don't see what you want on the lot? You can still get a No Bull deal on a special order with the assistance of your sales associate, or just go to BillFickFord.com. Click order here and design your new Ford today. Built for you, by you. Bill Fick Ford, I-45 South in Huntsville.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
I got it from the Greg. Thanks for joining us. Rob Hipp here in Austin, Texas. It is 23-18 as the Longhorns leading your Bearcats. Men's basketball with 7:33 to go. As the Bearcats at one point were shooting over 60%, they have now cooled off 8 of 17, 47%. 2 of 6 from downtown at 33%. And for the Horns, that's been the difference so far. The Bearcats have actually put up 3 more shots at 17. The Texas, 8 of 14, 57%, and 3 of 6 from three-point land. They've also made all 4 of their free throws. 5 turnovers for the Bearcats. Texas already has 8 in this ballgame. Sam Houston has been a force down in the paint, though. 12 points down in the paint. They have 8 second-chance points. And the Longhorns currently leading here, tying their largest lead at 5, 23-18. Bearcats, their largest lead was 5 at the 17:50 mark in the first half. Sam Houston went on an 8-0 scoring run also at that same time. There has been 4 lead changes, 2 ties. Bearcats have led for 6 minutes and 2 seconds, while the Horns 4 minutes and 49 seconds. As we're still in a timeout here, I want to remind you that our Bearcat fan text line is open. Feel free to text us. Let us know where you're listening from tonight. We'd love to hear from you. 512-522-9105. As we already have some messages coming in on that fan text line, our good friend Tony Minton from San Francisco joining us tonight in the booth. We appreciate you. And also our good friend Justin Kring saying, "Eat 'em up, Cats," as he is listening from home tonight. Also, Rhonda Ellisor joining us in the booth on Facebook Live. Deanna Thompson saying, "Have fun." Appreciate you, Deanna. Deneen Thompson, appreciate you. Dave Richardson also saying, "Looking good so far. Got to stay aggressive and keep forcing turnovers." How about our good friend William Hibner joining us? Eat 'em up, Cats. Listening from Houston, Texas tonight. And also our good friend Ken Holland. As we get back into action here in Austin, 23-18, 7:33 to go in the first half. And Allen at the free throw line here to shoot the free throw shots. And from the officials, I did not see, I don't believe that there was a flagrant foul. They did review it during that timeout, but it was just a regular common foul. And here's Allen at the line to shoot free throws here for the Horns. As he'll shrug his shoulders, takes a deep breath, bends his knees, right-handed delivery on the way. Good at the bottom of the net for Timmy Allen. Allen, a 70% free throw shooter entering this contest. And he's got 5 points so far tonight. 3 of 3 remaining perfect from that free throw line. Here on the left side, places one dribble down. Here's the shot on its way. This one rolls home. 25-18, Longhorns with their largest lead. 7:30 to go here in the first half. The Bearcats will bring it from left to right. Jaden Ray trapped in the backcourt. He'll throw it over as Jaron Cook is open. Swings it to Javion May. He slams it down with authority. Oh, mama, what a play by Javion May. Biggest dunk of the night. The first one will go to the Bearcats. Javion May, aggressive down low in the paint. From Jaden Ray to Jaron Cook. It's 25-20 Horns with a 5-point advantage. Ramey has it back on the left side of the left wing. He'll go down low here to Mitchell. Mitchell back up top as Ramey thought about a three. Now picks up his dribble. He'll swing it up top. Here's a three by Andrew Jones. That shot isn't there. And here come the Cats. Savion Flagg thought about a three from the left side. Floats this one up. And the ball poked around and it goes out of bounds off of Sam Houston. Savion there maybe trying to force something down low. I like the play though, and it does go out of bounds. And the Horns will have it back here. 5-point advantage, 6:43 to go here in the first is DeMarcus Lampley checking back into the game for Jaron Cook as he'll get a pat on the back from head coach Jason Hooten and assistant coach Bailey and Owens down there as well to cheer him on. Lampley back out there for the Cats. Inbound pass for the Horns. on the opposite end of the court. Here comes Allen on the front side. On the near side, moving from right to left with a right-handed dribble. Flag guarding him. He'll step into the front court. Right-handed pass goes over to Jones near the right wing. Now close to the baseline on the right side. Trying to drive in. Flips it up from the circle. That one good. Wow. Andrew Jones. Hard to guard that down there inside the circle as he laid it up off the left side of the glass and good. He's got 4 points, 2 of 3 from the field. 27-20, Bearcats trailing, 6:13 to go here in the first half. Jaden Ray, drop pass over right wing to Javion May. Now to Kian Scroggins, who checked in moments ago. Scroggins, two right-handed dribbles over to Ray near the right corner, 10 on the shot clock. As he turns it over, trying to feed it inside on Jones, and here comes Jones. Flip it back over Carr, right side. That shot's no good. Actually, it was Allen. And he's fouled, and he'll go to the line here to shoot two. So Jaden Ray will pick up his first personal and the 15th foul by Sam Houston as the horn's at the line here to shoot free throws. Allen taking some time here. He'll talk to the officials and now steps up to that free throw line where he's been perfect so far tonight. 6 points, 4 of 4 from the charity stripe here for Timmy Allen. Once again, he'll take a deep breath. One dribble, right-handed free throw on its way, and this one good. He remains perfect.
On the court for Texas, Jace
Febres. Febres is back in. Jace Febres back in for the Horns. As Marcus Carr will head over to the bench for the Horns. So it is Allen, Jones, Ramey, Febres, and Bishop on the court for the Horns. Flag, Lampley, May, Ray, and Scroggins out there for Sam Houston. That free throw missed by Allen, his first miss of the night. Horns were perfect before that one just moments ago. Here's Jaden Ray from left to right. Bearcats trailing 28-20, 5:45 to go here in the first half. High screen, Scroggins. Pass back over to Lampley, left wing. Finds Savion Flagg, thought about a three. Timmy Allen all in his face. Scroggins has it near the left elbow. Now to the right elbow as he is trapped down there. Picks up his dribble, Bishop. Back down low to Savion Flagg. Tries to slam it home and it got blocked. Savion Flagg hit the deck. Here come the Horns. It's Allen from right to left, weaving through traffic. He'll find his teammate Febres over on the right wing, and here's a three straight away. Jones, this one won't fall. The rebound to Javion May. The Bearcats catching a break here after the turnover. Jaden Ray has it in the backcourt all alone. Now crosses over center court on the right horn of the Horns logo. The left-handed dribble, Scroggins on a pick and roll down low. Here is Savion Flagg from the left wing, up top to Lampley. Scroggins again. Here's Lampley from downtown. Rattle it home to Marcus. Light him up, Lampley. Lampley pretty rigorous in his practice routine as he tries to make 10 three-pointers from each spot on the court down there. Horns have it back on the left side, poking it away. Jaden Ray has it. And we've got a foul there, though, as Ray was taken off to the right side. That would have been too easily. Allen, though, called for the foul. That's a tough break for Sam Houston because Ray was off to the races and he could have easily laid that one up as Damon Nicholas Jr. set at the scores table to check in. He'll come in for Savion Flagg. Flagg, 8 points, 4 of 7, played in 15 minutes. We'll head to the bench and Damon Nicholas Jr. in there for him now. He's played in 3 minutes so far tonight. Javion May will inbound just in front of some Longhorn students on the right side on his own side of the court. Bounce pass goes to Nicholas. As he'll retreat back, now finds Ray. Ray looks over his right shoulder to head coach Hooten. Right-handed dribble. Finds Kian Scroggins near the top of the three. So he'll try to shake his way over the left wing. Here's a three, Jaden Ray. Yes! Bury it at the bottom of the net for Jaden Ray. The Bearcats having a nice three-point night tonight. As they are now 4 of 8, 50%. From pay dirt behind the arc. 28-26, Horns. Lead by only two. It's a 6-0 run for the Bearcats. Here's a three from straight away. Rattles in, won't drop for Ramey, but the Horns with the rebound. It's Mitchell over on the left corner. And Lampley poking it around. Good defense there by DeMarcus Lampley, and it goes out of bounds. It will remain with the Horns. 28-26, Bearcats on that 6-0 run over the last minute after they trailed in this ballgame earlier by as many as 8 when it was 28-20. We'll step aside. We'll take a media timeout for 2 minutes from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Sam Houston Athletics would like to thank the following partners: Double Dave's Pizza, Emblem Properties, Enterprise Holdings, Fast Signs, Faust Distributing, and First Financial Bank. Thank you for supporting your Bearcats.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
The Bearcat Pavilion at Bauer Stadium is a new and exciting place to enjoy Bearcat football. Fans will find Smokin' Sammy's Barbecue, sodas, beer and wine, and a number of other food options from atop the southwest corner overlooking all of the action at Bauer Stadium. Bearcat Pavilion can be reserved on game days for pregame and or postgame private functions and may also be reserved for private events throughout the year. For more information about Bearcat Pavilion at Bauer Stadium, call 936-294-2701.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime One burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
Back at it here for the first time in 44 years as Texas men's basketball hosting Sam Houston at the historic Gregory Gymnasium. The Bearcats on a 6-0 run over the last minute to get back to within two, 28-26, 3:58 to go. As Sam Houston recovering from the shooting slump, 11 of 22 from the field, 50%. They are 4 of 8 out of those from the three-point line tonight. On the flip side for the University of Texas, 9 of 18, 3 of 9 from the three-point line, but they're also getting the line where they're 7 of 8 tonight. Bearcats have turned it over 8 times. They have forced 11 Texas turnovers, 14 down in the paint for the Bearcats compared to only 6 for Texas. That was part of the game plan, is keeping the horns away from the inside. So far tonight, Sam Houston has followed their game plan religiously, and it's paid off for him here. Bearcats led by as many as 5 at one point earlier in this first half. They trailed by as many as 7, but as I said just a few moments ago, they have now cut it to within 2 points. 28-26 as Andrew Jones will inbound here for the horns on the left side under his own side. So he'll go up top to Brock Cunningham. Cunningham near the left wing with 10 on the shot clock. Nicholas Jr., good defense down here. Dante Powers out there. Here's DeMarcus Lampley guarding Andrew Jones. Over to Allen, wide open, left wing three, not there, and this ball goes out of bounds, and it'll go right back to the Bearcats. It's all claps for the coaching staff here in front of us for Sam Houston. Nicholas Jr. will inbound just in front of his own bench on the left side. Sam Houston will move it here from left to right. Jaden Ray has it in the backcourt as Marcus Carr guarding him. Ray, left-handed dribble, drop it off over to Powers. Powers rotates to the right wing. Now the bounce pass from Nicholas over to Ray. Ray near the left wing as he drops it down over to Kean Scroggins, and Scroggins is fouled as he was driving in. Coach Hooten happy there with the efforts by his Bearcat team. 13 on the shot clock, ball goes out of bounds. And the foul is called on Brock Cunningham. That is his first personal, and I believe the third team foul by Texas. So Jaden Ray will inbound on the right baseline under his own side on the right. Hold the ball at his chest. Now over the head pass goes to Nicholas Jr. on the right wing. He is guarded by Jones. Wants to work this one inside. Floats up a shot, and a miracle drops in off the glass for Nicholas as he was partially blocked driving in, but that ball fell, and we are tied at 28 apiece here in Austin. Been a fun one so far. With 3 minutes to go here in the first half, Carr has it up top for the horns on the left side. Scroggins and Jaden Ray there trapping him. Now over to Allen from the free throw line. To the left elbow, loses his handle. Here's Carr, left wing three, good at the bottom of the net. Carr will stop that shooting slump. Sam Houston has made 3 of their last 3 from the field. Trailing 31-28, 2:39 to go here in the first half. Powers over to Nicholas, working from the left baseline. Kean Scroggins, a jumper. This one isn't good from just outside the left elbow. Hooten shaking his head, not happy with the shot selection there. Jones has it back up top. Rotate over to Allen. Now the pass to Carr. Carr guarded by Scroggins on the right wing. as he's trying to work inside now from that right side. He'll pick up his dribble, floats one from the circle, and that one's good. Little two-point shot from just outside the semicircle, 33-28. Texas extends it back to a five-point advantage. Sam Houston on the right side. It's Jaden Ray. He is guarded by Timothy Allen. Ray splitting through two defenders, finds Lampley from the right wing. This one off the left side of the rim, and it won't drop. Here come the horns from right to left. Carr has it quickly back on the left side to the left wing. Guarded by Dante Powers. Scroggins reaches out. Now the pass goes to Jones. Left wing three. This one rattles out. No good. A rebound, Dante Powers. Powers wants to run quickly, weaving through traffic off the left side. Throws up a shot. It's nowhere close. Tried to force one in. Jones got the rebound, and here comes Jones back the other way as he'll spin one up from inside, and this one falls for Jones. So both players back-to-back. Wasn't impressive shots, but the beneficiary there goes to Jones after his hustle kept up with it. 35-28. The Longhorns up front, 1:15 to go, and we've got a timeout by Sam Houston. We'll take it for 30 seconds, 35-28, 1:15 to go here in the first half. It's a 7-0 run over the last 1:36 from the Horns. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
35-28, Sam Houston trailing here. In the capital of Texas, here on the campus of Texas, 1:15 to go, Longhorns leading. Again, welcome back into the booth. Thanks for joining us tonight for Sam Houston men's basketball here on the Bearcat Sports Radio Network. It's a 7-0 run over the last 1:36 for the Horns after the Bearcats tied it up. Just a few moments ago, Horns have led by as many as 8 when it was 28-20. Sam Houston back with it here, though, on the right side is Jaden Ray. He is guarded by Ramey. Over to Nicholas. Back up top, Scroggins. Swing pass from his right hip over to Jaden Ray. Bounce down low to Savion Flagg with 10 on the shot clock. As he's trying to back down a defender, turn around. He'll pass over here to Nicholas. He'll take a three. That one is blocked. Gets his own block up in the air, though. And we've got the officials here stopping play because they reset the shot clock, and the official said, wait a minute. That one wasn't even anywhere close, so they're going to reset it back to 5 seconds here on the shot clock. I think everybody knew down there that it was not a reset except the operator. So we'll get back into action here. 5 on the shot clock for Sam Houston. They will inbound on the right side under their own rim as Bearcats have it here. Here's Savion Flagg for 3. This one off the front of the rim. That one wasn't close. The Horns trying to haul in the rebound, and they've got it. Almost went out of bounds. Here comes Marcus Carr from right to left. Trying to work inside on Jaden Ray. Over to Ramey on the left wing. Kian Scroggins guarding him. Now over to Nicholas Jr. Down low on the defense. Here's a right wing three. Good. Buried by Marcus Carr. Marcus Carr with 13 points leading all scorers. Bearcats leading or trailing now with the largest deficit, 38-28. About a second, half a second differential. So the Bearcats will have to shoot the final shot, of course. Down to 10 seconds as the fans here, the students on their feet at the Greg. Jaden Ray down to 5. 4 he goes. On the left wing, Ray behind the back with 1, and he's fouled. Good job there by Jaden Ray trying to work inside. 1 second remaining on the shot clock. That foul is on Courtney Ramey. It is his first personal and the fourth team foul by the Horns. 1.9 they will put back on the clock, so it's going to have to be a quick pass and shoot here for the Bearcats as Damon Nicholas Jr. has it in front of some of the students on the right side on that sideline. Flag is out there, Scroggins, Lampley, and Jaden Ray. 1.9 on the clock here in the first half. Bearcats trailing 38-28. They'll have to go quickly here and put up a shot. Nicholas Jr. guarded there by Christian Bishop as he'll try to get it in quickly. We'll whistle it back into play. Here's Nicholas. Bounce pass. Savion Flagg. He's got to shoot it with a hand in his face at the buzzer off the back of the rim. Shot will fall. Texas leads at halftime 38-28. It's been a fun first half. We'll see if the Bearcats can continue to hold on as we'll step aside and take an extended break. We'll be back in a moment with halftime stats and more from Ben Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship. Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest. Conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville, the Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
Many family celebrations occur during the holidays with plenty of memories being made then too. I'm Greg Smith, owner of Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home. Because we are a family-owned business, we can be counted on to help you plan your family members' perfect celebration of life. We have planned and arranged thousands of services. When it's time, you can trust us to help you and your family plan a remembrance to recognize a life well lived. We're Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home because every life deserves to be celebrated.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep, along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
For the best customer service and best deal on your new Ford, head to Bill Fick Ford in Huntsville, your Noble headquarters. Thinking something sporty and great on gas? Check out the 2022 Ford Explorers and Expeditions. Don't see what you want on the lot? You can still get a Noble deal on a special order with the assistance of your sales associate, or just go to BillFickFord.com. Click order here and design your new Ford today. Built for you, by you. Bill Fick Ford, I-45 South in Huntsville.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
101.7 KSAM and the Bearcat Sports Network welcome you to the Bearcat Basketball Halftime Show. Now let's go back courtside with Rob Hipp. All right, friends, halftime here in Austin, Texas at the historic Gregory Gymnasium, 38-28. Longhorns end that first half on a 10-0 run over the last 2 minutes 51 seconds, making four of their last five shots. Sam Houston blistering at one point over 60% from the field. They have cooled off to only 41% on a scoring drought, 0 of their last six from the field. They did not score in the final 3:13 of that first half. It's always my joy and honor when we're down here in Austin to talk to my former broadcast colleague and the University of Texas alum, Mr. Matt Leshman. Matt, how you doing tonight, my friend? Good to hear from you.
Rob, doing good watching this game. One of the few people I am to have the Longhorn Network here in Arizona. So watching this game, and very interesting to see a ball game, basketball being played from Gregory Gym. First game that counts there since 1977. What a great venue for basketball.
Matt, you know, under a new head coach now here for Texas, as Shaka Smith was here for quite, or Shaka Smart here for some time, but you know, this Sam Houston squad, it's always a tough contest for Texas. It's never just a gimme game. It was a close matchup last year. Just kind of your thoughts in that first half, man.
Well, you and I were talking this afternoon, and, you know, Sam Houston coming into this game 2-4, that did not look like a 2-4 ball club. They were pushing the number 7 Horns to the limit there, that little 10-0 run to give them a little bit of breathing room. But, boy, that Javian May dunk, that's going to be on SportsCenter top 10. That was vicious, man. That was a that was a highlight reel play right there. But Sam Houston looked very poised early. I mean, that's not an easy place to play. They don't play basketball there much, obviously, but that's a volleyball venue, and it's very tough for other opposing volleyball teams to come in there and play Texas, which will happen on Thursday night in the volleyball tournament. But I'm impressed with Sam Houston. They had a little bit of a bobble there in the last 4 minutes or so, and Texas can really thank Marcus Carr for that lead they have at halftime. Three of these guys, Rob, Marcus Carr, Trey Mitchell, and Timmy Allen, those are all transfers that new head coach Chris Beard brought in, and all three of them are starters, and all three of them are playing pretty well.
Hey, man, you know, a lot happening at UT. Of course, you went to school here. You've seen some changes over your time. It's been some time since you've been here. I know up in Arizona now, but the historic game being played here at Gregory Gymnasium, you talked about that, and then the final season of the Irwin Center, man. Kind of your thoughts about that and the new Moody Center that's being built.
Well, lots of great memories at the Irwin Center. Just a cavernous place. I mean, you've been there several times, obviously, but I thought at the beginning of this game, that Texas was getting used to the smaller venue. With the, you know, depth perception is a little bit different in that place with 3,500 students as far as shooting the ball. They had to bring those rims over from the Irwin Center, and they've got to take them back over there for the women's game. But, you know, moving into the Moody Center, everybody's excited about that new venue. And the Irwin Center, you know, built in the 70s, and that's kind of run its course, we know, for several years. And with Chris Beard at the helm and really embracing the traditions of the program, and really, really, they showed on the intro here tonight on Longhorn Network of him with taking pictures with students outside. He's been having pizza parties with the students. He's really engaged with, you know, he's an alum. He graduated the same year I did from UT, so they're hoping for big things from Chris Beard, and we know what he did at Texas Tech, so I'm hoping that that's a tremendous hire for the Longhorns.
Well, Matt, it's considered a throwback game here tonight. I kind of described it as a real high-energy high school contest with, of course, the college flavor added to it, and it's just a really neat atmosphere for the students here. It's a student-only. They're going to try to do this once a year. And how about the shoes that the coaches are wearing tonight? They were designed by Jake DeFankelis. They have the names of every Texas coach inscribed on the side, commemorating every coach who coached the Longhorns here from 1930 to 1977. Matt, as always, good to catch up from you. Any final comments before I let you go, my friend?
Hey, Rob, just really awesome to hear you doing your work there and following along with you as I'm watching the game on television. And we'll talk to you soon. Thanks, man.
All right, once again, Matt Leshman, my former broadcast analyst for many years before I got to Sam Houston. Always good to check up with him, and also the former the University of Texas alum. You can't be a former alum. He's the alum of the University of Texas. We'll step aside and take a break. 7:45 to go. Before we get things started in the second half, it's been all Texas, 38-28, but Sam Houston holding strong. We'll see what they bring out. For now, though, we'll step aside, we'll take another break, and when we come back, we'll talk more about halftime stats. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcat Sports Radio Network.
Many family celebrations occur during the holidays, with plenty of memories being made then too. I'm Greg Smith, owner of Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home. Because we are a family-owned business, we can be counted on to help you plan your family members' perfect celebration of life. We have planned and arranged thousands of services. When it's time, you can trust us to help you and your family plan a remembrance to recognize a life well lived. We're Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home, because every life deserves to be celebrated.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep, along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Need service work on your vehicle? Then drop on by Wiesner Huntsville and meet the new service and shop managers to see what better customer service feels like. Meet their GM factory-trained technicians who are skilled with state-of-the-art factory diagnostic equipment. Wiesner service hours Monday through Saturday are convenient, and local shuttle service is readily available. Experience the service difference at Wiesner Huntsville.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance,
insurance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest. Conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville, the Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
Welcome back, friends. 5 minutes to go here at halftime on the campus of Texas, University of Texas, 38-28 as Longhorns leading your Bearcats men's basketball. And it's been a turnaround night tonight for Marcus Carr of the University of Texas. He only, in 29 minutes, he was 0-3, 0-1 from downtown. Only had 2 points in the previous matchup on Wednesday versus California Baptist. Those points came off of free throws. But again, here tonight, it's a turnaround night for that young man. 13 points leading all scores. He is the only player on both sides of the court in double digits. 5 of 8 from the field, 3 of 5 from three-point land. He has an assist and a foul and a turnover in 17 minutes. So a night after only scoring 2, he's got 13 so far tonight. We'll step aside. We'll take another break. We'll have the second half coming up. When we come back from Van Wagner, this is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Many family celebrations occur during the holidays with plenty of memories being made then too. I'm Greg Smith, owner of Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home. Because we are a family-owned business, we can be counted on to help you plan your family members' perfect celebration of life. We have planned and arranged thousands of services. When it's time, you can trust us to help you and your family plan a remembrance to recognize a life well lived. We're Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home because every life deserves to be celebrated.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship. Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest. Conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville, the Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
For the best customer service and best deal on your new Ford, head to Bill Fick Ford in Huntsville, your Noble headquarters. Thinking something sporty and great on gas? Check out the 2022 Ford Explorers and Expeditions. Don't see what you want on the lot? You can still get a Noble deal on a special order with the assistance of your sales associate, or just go to BillFickFord.com. Click order here and design your new Ford today. Built for you, by you. Bill Fick Ford, I-45 South in Huntsville.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
Sam Houston Athletics would like to thank the following partners: Double Dave's Pizza, Emblem Properties, Enterprise Holdings, Fast Signs, Faust Distributing, and First Financial Bank. Thank you for supporting your Bearcats.
This has been the Bearcat Basketball Halftime Show. We'll be right back with the second half of tonight's game on the Bearcat Sports Network and 101.7 KSAM.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association for only $35 a year. Your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
Back at it, friends, here from Austin, Texas at the historic Gregory Gymnasium. The Longhorns leading your Bearcats 38-28. Men's basketball on a Monday night. Thanks for joining us on the Bearcats Sports Radio Network. In that first half, the Bearcats cooled down to 41% from the field, shooting 12 of 29. The Horns on the flip side, 13 of 24 for 54%. From downtown, the Bearcats 36% on 4 of 11 from that three-point line. The Horns not faring much better either, 5 of 13 at 38%. Bearcats did not make any free throws. They were 0 for 1, only getting to that line one time in the and-one play from Savion Flagg, where he's only a 38% free throw shooter. He missed the and-one. For the Horns, 7 of 8 from the charity stripe tonight at 88%. There has been 6 turnovers by Sam Houston, 8 points scored off of 5 Longhorns turnovers. And Sam Houston cooling things off on the rebounding side tonight as well, an area that they have dramatically improved on this season. Only 14 boards tonight, 9 on the defensive side, 5 on the offense. Bearcats, though, leading second chance points at 8, only 2 off the bench. They have scored 16. That's double the points down in the paint, only 8 for the Longhorns down in the paint. For Sam Houston, with Kuba Krawowski down there in limited minutes, he can block him. But tonight, no blocks for Sam Houston. They do have 2 steals and 4 assists. In that second half, they got to do a better job of distributing the ball, and they've really got to control things down inside the paint, continuing that for the Longhorns. But an area, too, that they've got to work on is containing the three-point shot. Here come the Bearcats as we get things underway here in the second half from Austin, Texas. As Jaden Ray has it on the right wing, we'll go down to Ipe on the baseline. He's double-teamed on that right side, flings this one over to Flagg. Here's Lampley, left corner three, off the back of the iron. But the rebound, Lampley, he claws his own, handoff down to Javion May, right side, good for the Bearcats, Javion May. It was an assist from DeMarcus Lampley, who stayed alive after he missed the three. The Horns will bring it back here from left to right. They were on a 10-0 run before that one earlier. Here comes the Horns on the right side. It is Timmy Allen, a three here. That's an air ball from Mitchell from the left wing. Sam Houston wanting to work slowly here as Jaden Ray will bring it to the front court. Here in the second half, now moving from right to left. On the far side is Ray. Ball in his left hand, now crosses over to his right. Bounce pass down to Ipe near the right baseline. Guarded by Mitchell. Turn around, way too strong. Javion May there to clean it up, and it goes right back to Tristan Ipe. Here's Savion Flagg from the left wing, trying to drive in through 3 defenders. And boy, the fast lane was open for Savion Flagg. He's fouled, and he'll go to the line shooting 2. As he split through 3 defenders trying to find the basket off the left side. But he's got to make the free throws here. Savion Flagg, the leading scorer, or the second leading scorer tonight for Sam Houston with 8 points, 4 of 9. He is 0 for 1 from the charity stripe, a 38% free throw shooter. Here's the first one. Rattles in and out, won't fall. As Jace Febbers will check out of the game, and back in for the Horns is Andrew Jones. Flagg here, second free throw coming up. Here it is. This one no good either. He has missed all 3 of them tonight. And it remains 38-30, Texas by 8. Here comes the Horns back down into the hands of Allen. On the right wing, guarded by Flagg, right-handed dribble. Now the swing, chest pass over to Carr. Now to the left wing, Ramey. Javion May guarding him. Ramey trying to work it inside. And Javion May maybe just a little too aggressive there as he pokes in. That's his first personal and the first team foul of the second half. So a 20 on the shot clock. Inbounding here is Timmy Allen, the 6'6" senior forward. 90 career games entering this one here tonight. As Jones has it for the Horns on the right wing. DeMarcus Lampley, the pesky defense up in his face. High pass goes over to Ramey on the left wing. Down low, Mitchell. trying to shake his way inside, and it's turned over. Lampley has it. Up top to Jaden Ray. Turn on the speed, baby. Left side, good for Jaden Ray. And the Bearcats showing some pressure here in the second. The assist machine is cranking out now for Sam Houston. It's 38-32, 18 minutes to go here in the ball game. As the Horns have it back on the right side, it's Courtney Ramey. That's a long shot here, won't fall. Rebound, Savion Flagg, and here come the Bearcats. Jaden Ray so patiently brings it into the front court on the far side from right to left. Carr is guarding him. As he'll bounce pass down low to Tristan Ipe. Ipe trying to slice through defenders. He'll find Ray back on the right wing. Ray has it. Carr on it. Ray flips it over his left shoulder to Ipe. He'll take this one over to Savion Flagg. Yes! Buried it at the bottom of the net for Savion Flagg. Raise the flag, baby, and the Bearcats have cut it to within three. 38-35. As the Horns bring it back into the front court from left to right, it is Jones with Lampley guarding him. A quick pass over to the left wing, drops off to Mitchell. Here's a three from Jones, and that'll get the crowd back into it. As he buried the three from the right wing. 3 minutes gone here in the second half, 41-35, Bearcats trailing by six. Ray on the far side, right-handed dribble, Carr guarding him. Near the right wing, now the pass from the numbers over to Savion Flagg, double team. Lampley, left wing. Over to Ipe, down near the left corner. Baseline, the left side, throws it over. Good ball movement here from Flagg to Lampley. Lampley floats one inside. He's fouled. Nope. It's an offensive foul. Lampley charged with the offensive foul as Texas took the charge. The foul there on DeMarcus Lampley. That is his first personal and the second team foul in just over 3 minutes here in the final frame of play. 41-35, Bearcats trailing. They have outscored UT 7-3 to start things out of the gate here in the second. Inbounding is Allen for the Horns, moving from left to right over to Ramey. Ramey zigzagging through defenders on the far side, has the ball in his right hand. Javion May with a threatening defense out near the left wing. He's all in front of him. Here's a pass over to the right corner as Jones hot steps his way inside, bounces it off the right side, and it's good for Andrew Jones. Boy, Andrew Jones makes it look so easy. He has 9, 4 of 7 from the field in 17 minutes. Back up to an 8-point advantage for the Horns. Here's the Bearcats, though. Jaden Ray on the right side. Moves over to the left, standing on the left horn of the Longhorn logo, high screen Ipe. Ray over his shoulder to Lampley, thought about a three, now puts the ball back down over to Savion Flagg on the left wing. Savion splits through two defenders from inside the circle, ball poked away, holds on to it, puts up a shot, and it rattles in for Savion Flagg. Good footwork there by Flagg, able to stay with it, and the Bearcats have made three of their last three. Here's a steal by Lampley, left wing three. This one no good. And the rebound into the hands of Carr. That would have been huge for the Bearcats. Here comes the Horns back over. Left corner three, Ramey, yes.
Ramey from Allen.
Ramey making his first three-pointer of the night. He's got 10 points now, and there are three Longhorns in double digits. Jones, Carr, and Ramey. Bearcats back with it on the right side, trailing here by 9. 46-37, 15 minutes to go in the game. Ray down to Ipe on the left baseline, trying to work inside. Has his dribble, he's trapped by two. Throws this one up top to Jaden Ray. Thought about a three, two on the clock, floats it from inside. He is fouled, and Jaden Ray to the line, shooting two. Good eye and good coordination there by Jaden Ray. 15:01 to go. Bearcats trailing 46-37. We'll step aside for 2 minutes on a media timeout from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
Sam Houston Bearcats are national champions. Don't miss the excitement of Bearcat football. Season tickets and single game seats still available. Call the Bearcat ticket office at 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearcats.com/tickets.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Season tickets are on sale for 2021-22 basketball season. Season tickets start as low as $99. One price gets you both men's and women's Bearcat basketball. Call 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearcats.com/tickets to secure your seat today.
Welcome back, friends. It is loud here in the historic Gregory Gymnasium in Austin, Texas, on the campus of the University of Texas, 46-37. It's Bearcat men's basketball trailing as the Horns, a nice little three of their last three run. And Sam Houston pulled to within three a little bit earlier. So far for the Bearcats, Savion Flagg with 13 points in this game. He's a leading scorer for Sam Houston, averaging 19 a game in all six games so far this season. DeMarcus Lampley behind him, averaging 11. Savion Flagg, how about this, 116 total points through six games. DeMarcus Lampley at 67. Savion has got to have more of a supporting cast behind him. Coach Hooten's talked about this Bearcat team saying, look, it may be 2-4 on paper, but this team is improving game in and game out. And when you're going up against the seventh-ranked team in the nation and you're only trailing by single digits in the second half, that's pretty impressive. Every time the Horns have made a run, Bearcats have been able to respond. They just have not been able to get over the hump. The Bearcats led by five when it was 10-5 at 13:30, or 14-12, rather, back in the first when it was 13:31 to go. Their largest lead was at five when it was 10-5. For Texas, they've led by as many as 10, 38-28. Their last lead, 46-37, as we stand right now with 15:01 remaining here in Austin. More messages coming in on the Bearcat fan text line. Jonathan Knobloch, appreciate you joining us. Also, our good friend Stephanie Pitts sharing on the Bearcats tonight. And also my wonderful mother just up the road in Georgetown saying, let's go, Cats, eat them up. Jaden Ray makes the first free throw coming out of the media timeout. He'll have one more for the Bearcats. 5 of 6 entering this season. Here's the second one. This one on its way, good as well for Jaden Ray. And it's 46-39, Horns by 7, 15:01 to go. Allen has it here for the Longhorns. On the near side, moving from left to right. Has it. Over to the left wing, it's Allen, the senior forward, guarded by Savion Flagg. Handoff, give and go back to Allen near the top of the three, poked away by Tristan Ipe into the backcourt, and down to 10 on the shot clock. As Allen trying to work something inside from the top, now passes over his left shoulder to Ramey. Ramey guarded by Cook, down to 3-2, and a block and a foul here called by Jaron Cook. That was way before the shot. So tough there for Jaron Cook. That is his first personal and the third team foul for the Bearcats here in the second half. So that'll take the shot clock back up to 20 as Timothy Allen to inbound here on the right side on his own sideline just in front of the student section across from the scorer's table. Over to Jones, back to Allen, guarded by Flagg. Allen at the top, crossover dribble, high screen set up by Bishop. Pass goes back to Askew. Sees there on the left wing, over to Allen at the top, now from the free throw line to the right elbow. Javion May poking it away. On the court is Tristan Ipe. Javion May falls over the pile, and it's a jump ball. Possession arrow stays with Texas. Possession arrow. The defense there by Sam Houston, though.
Possession arrow, Texas.
So the possession arrow will stay with Texas. And only 1 second remaining on the shot clock. Askew's going to have to get this one in quickly here. He's under his own baseline on the right side of the rim. 1 second on the shot clock. 14:12 to go here in the game. But he'll have to quickly throw it in and look for a give and go. Pass is inside, and shot clock violation. Sam Houston holding him here. They'll get it right back. 46-39, 14:11 to go here in Austin. Bearcats trailing. On the court for Sam Houston, it is Flagg, Cook, May, Ipe, and Ray. For the Longhorns, Allen, Jones, Ramey, Askew, and Bishop. Allen, Jones, and Ramey all in double digits. As Ray and Flagg for Sam Houston, they're in double-digit land now.
Jaden Ray has it on the left wing. He's guarded by Askew, right-handed dribble, over, rotates to the right wing. Now backpedals to the Big 12 logo near the right side. Pass over, Savion flag three, left wing, won't fall. Javion May poking around, Ipe down on the court. It goes back over to flag, and now we've got a whistle. And the Bearcats, aggressive defense. We'll see if it's a foul against the Longhorns. It is. It's a foul on Timmy Allen. It's a third team foul by the Horns, the second personal on Allen. And Askew will head over to the bench, and Carr checking back in for him. Jaden Ray to inbound on the right on the left baseline under his own rim on the right side. As he'll get the inbound pass here over to Jaron Cook, right wing. Cook, he'll take a three. This one rattles in and out. Savion Flagg had the position, the rebound. The putback's not there either, and the goes right over to Ramey on the rebound as he was on that left side. From left to right, here come the Horns. It's Carr near the left wing. Carr backpedaling. Chest pass goes over to Jones on the right wing, guarded by May. High screen by Bishop on a give and go. Back over to Allen on the left wing. Down low, the ball to Bishop. And we got a whistle and a foul here against Sam Houston down inside the paint. He's not in the act of shooting. We'll see who this one's on.
Personal foul number 12.
It's on Tristan Ipe. That is his third personal and the fourth team foul as Ipe will head back over to the sideline, getting a chat with head coach Jason Hooten, who's giving him a pat on the back, very happy with his play. And Kian Scroggins will check back in. So it is Scroggins, Cook, May, Ray, and a flag on the court for the Bearcats. Horns trying to inbound here, and quickly this one goes back into the backcourt all the way to Andrew Jones, guarded by May. On the right side, now rotates over to the left wing. Good defense here by May with his left hand poking inside. Ball now into the hands over to Ramey. Ramey tries to flip one up, and a whistle here and a foul against Sam Houston. This one is going on Jaron Cook, his second and five team fouls, just like that for the Bearcats. Trailing 46-39, 13-12 to go here in the ball game. As Carr inbounding for the Horns, 20 on the shot clock, under his own rim on the right side. Pass goes down to Allen, down low to Bishop. Inside the paint, Scroggins thought he had a block, but he did not. He had a foul and a one.
Mitchell to the basket.
So Mitchell the and one, the foul on Kian Scroggins. It's his first personal, already 16 fouls for the Bearcats, and Coach Hooten is not happy with Kian Scroggins right now. Hooten followed Scroggins all the way back to his seat on the bench. Here's Mitchell for the and one. 48-39. Horns leading by nine. As Brock Cunningham checking back into the ballgame as well and heading over to the bench is Timmy Allen for the Horns. So here's Mitchell on the right side for the and one. Kuba Kowalski checking back in for the Bearcats in place of Kian Scroggins. Mitchell. He'll bend his knees, right-handed free throw shot, bounces in and good. It went off the front of the rim, then off the back and dropped through. It's back to the largest lead for the Horns, 49-39, 13 minutes to go here in Austin. As Jaden Ray has it on the near side. The left-handed dribble from right to left. Kuba Kowalski, high screen, Ray over to the right wing, just on top of the Big 12 logo on that right side. Kowalski, high screen. Here comes Ray over to Cook, left corner three. This one too strong. Kowalski, though, hauling in the rebound. Get it, big 7'2" man. Over to Jaden Ray on the left wing. He'll go inside the paint. Throws up an awkward shot, and it's blocked. It goes out of bounds off of Sam Houston. Mitchell knocked it off the hip of Jaden Ray, and it's a turnover, and it goes right back to the Horns. They're already tied for their largest lead at 49-39 with 12:40 to go here in the game. They can extend that to the largest lead of the night here on a point coming up. As the Horns have it on the far side from left to right, Ramey guarded by Cook. Ramey from the left hand to the right hand. Crossover near the right wing. Picks up his dribble. Now swing pass off his left hip. Goes into the hands of Jones. Back up top over to Ramey. Ramey working off the high screen from Mitchell. He'll take a long jumper from the left wing. That shot isn't there. High rebound goes to Savion Flagg, and we've got a whistle here. It's going to be against Texas. Called on Brock Cunningham. That is his second and the fourth team foul by the Horns here in the second half. 12:15 remaining, Horns leading by 10, 49-39. They made four of their last five. However, for the Bearcats, 0 of their last six. They have not scored in almost 3 minutes. They have got to score a basket here. Here's Jaden Ray on the near side from right to left, stepping over the Texas logo at center court. The left-handed dribble swings this one down to Savion Flagg from the left baseline. And he was driving inside, and that ball is a foul. as Andrew Jones thought he stripped it. Instead, a foul is called here on Andrew Jones. That is his first and the 15th foul by Texas. 49-39, that'll take us to a media timeout. Bearkats trying to put something together here in the final 12 minutes. We'll step aside and take a break for 2 minutes from Van Wagner. This is the Bearkats Sports Radio Network.
Push Medical Services in Huntsville provides personalized, high-quality health care to meet your individual needs. Health concerns? Need to see a doctor? Heart issues? Need a vaccine? Dr. Henry Burkholder of Push Medical Services strives to address all of your health concerns. Most major health plans are accepted, as well as cash pay. Push Medical Services provides the most affordable care. Don't neglect health concerns. Visit Push Medical Services. For more information, visit pushmedical.org. That's pushmedical.org.
The Bearkat Pavilion at Bauer Stadium is a new and exciting place to enjoy Bearkat football. Fans will find Smokin' Sammy's Barbecue, sodas, beer and wine, and a number of other food options from atop the southwest corner overlooking all of the action at Bauer Stadium. Bearkat Pavilion can be reserved on game days for pregame and or postgame private functions and may also be reserved for private events throughout the year. For more information about Bearkat Pavilion at Bauer Stadium, call 936-294-2701.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearkat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
I got it, friends, from Austin, Texas. I'm Rob Hipp. Thanks for joining us. This game made possible in part by our good friends at HEB. No store does more than my HEB. Also, a reminder as Bearcat football playoff gets underway. Playoff football is back at Bauer Stadium Saturday, December the 4th at 2 p.m. as Bearcats will host Incarnate Word after their overtime victory over SFA. The road back to the national championship goes through Huntsville. Get your tickets today and don't miss 1 minute of the action. Call the Bearkat ticket office at 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearkats.com/tickets. Let's pack the house and eat them up, cats. We're back into here in Austin, Texas. Men's basketball trailing Texas 49-39. UT, the seventh-ranked team in the nation, their only loss this season to number one Gonzaga. But tonight, the Bearkats, they do not look like a 2-4 team against this top-ranked, one of the top-10-ranked University of Texas team. The assist machine has been out there, though, for Texas's Timmy Allen. He's dished out 6 assists in this ballgame. Marcus Carr leading all scores with 13 on the court for the Horns. Here come the Bearkats as they'll inbound coming out of the timeout. Jaden Ray all the way up top over to Javion May. Back over to Ray near the half-court line. Kuba Krawowski trying to set up a high screen. Ray tells him to move out, though. Here's Javion May at the top. One left-handed dribble, handoff over to Ray. Ray works off the high screen from Krawowski over the right side. Krawowski slam it home! Alley-oop to Kuba Krawowski! What a play by the Bearcats and the assist to Jaden Ray. I think so far that's the first alley-oop we've seen this season by the Bearcats. They've been trying to set up that play. They have not been effective, but that time a wide-open Krawowski. Here's Allen back the other way for three. Yes. It's actually Andrew Jones. And Jones buried it. That's his second three-pointer. He's got 14 for the Horns. Here come the Bearcats back over. Jaron Cook left wing trailing 52-41. 11-point Texas advantage. 11:06 to go here in the game. Back over to Cook. Now back over to Savion Flagg to Cook right corner and pass over to Savion Flagg. Long three with a hand in his face. Good at the bottom of the net. Raise the flag for Savion Flagg from way downtown in the parking lot. And the Bearcats answer the three moments ago by Allen. 52-44, 10:45 to go here in the game. Allen has it back over to the right wing to the hands of Carr. High screen Krawowski. Carr. Stepping back from the right wing. Pass goes up top to Allen. Allen trying to work inside the baseline. Hop step, and it's blocked from behind by Savion Flagg. Boy, he got his big right Bearcat claw on the back of that ball and knocked it out of bounds with four on the shot clock. Javion May will head back over to the bench. Hooten talking to him, holding his hand as he walks him back, having a nice chat with him. Here come the Horns with four on the shot clock, inbounding. On the right side, quickly up top over to Mitchell. Right wing three, Kowalski in his face, and that one's good. When Mitchell had a nice chat with Kowalski on the way back. Not sure about what, because Gilbert Kowalski doesn't say anything. He just plays the game. Here come the Bearcats, trailing 55-44. Jaden Ray at the top of the three, wiggling through defenders. Now over to Savion Flagg, and he stepped out of bounds, and it's a turnover.
Texas ball.
Hooten having a very animated discussion with Savion Flagg. Savion Flagg is teachable, and he shakes his head in agreement with Coach Hooten. Savion, of course, a graduate transfer from Texas A&M, showing his loyalty to this university because Sam Houston's Jason Hooten was the first to reach out to Savion Flagg early on in his career. Of course, went to A&M and then came back here to Sam Houston to finish out. It's 55-44, Horns on the right side. They've got the lead. Askew, this ball turned over. Great defense by Sam Houston. As Ramey was a miscommunication with Askew. 55-44, 9:50 to go here in Austin. Bearcats trailing by 11. The Horns have made six of their last eight. Sam Houston trying to get back on some sort of track here. It's Jaden Ray to the left wing with a left-handed dribble. Guarded by Marcus Carr. Ray over to Savion Flagg. Trying to clear out with his left hand. This one poked away, but able to hold on to it. Over to Askew. Throws it up to Kowalski at 7-2. This one knocked from behind by Ramey out of bounds with 10 on the shot clock. Trying to take advantage of that 7'2" big man down there, the center for Sam Houston. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Bounce pass to Flagg from Ray, and it goes out of bounds off Flagg.
Texas ball.
He couldn't hold on to it. It will go back to Texas, 55-44, as the Horns quickly over the right side. This one in the face of Kowalski, and it's good for Courtney Ramey off the left baseline. Sam Houston did not get back on defense. Coach Bailey in front of us was yelling at Savion Flagg to get back over there, and Jaden Ray calls a timeout as he brings it to center court just in front of the scorer's table. 30-second break, 57-44. Texas has their largest advantage with 9:11 to go here in Austin. We'll be back in 30 seconds from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Push Medical Services in Huntsville provides personalized, high-quality health care to meet your individual needs. Health concerns? Need to see a doctor? Heart issues? Need a vaccine? Dr. Henry Burkholder of Push Medical Services strives to address all of your health concerns. Most major health plans are accepted, as well as cash pay. Push Medical Services provides the most affordable care. Don't neglect health concerns. Visit Push Medical Services. For more information, visit pushmedical.org. That's pushmedical.org.
57-44 here in Austin on the campus of the University of Texas. 9:11 to go. Sam Houston men's basketball trailing the Longhorns tonight. It's been a shooting frenzy for Texas. They have made seven of their last nine shots to extend this lead. Sam Houston got it back to within two just a few moments ago, but they have not been able to recover here so far. And the Bearcats trying to find something. We'll stretch to a 60-second break and a media timeout. We'll be back in 60 seconds from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Many family celebrations occur during the holidays with plenty of memories being made then too. I'm Greg Smith, owner of Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home. Because we are a family-owned business, we can be counted on to help you plan your family members' perfect celebration of life. We have planned and arranged thousands of services. When it's time, you can trust us to help you and your family plan a remembrance to recognize a life well lived. We're Sam Houston Memorial Funeral Home because every life deserves to be celebrated.
Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Artec Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
It's loud here at Gregory Gymnasium. Rob Hipp joining you. Thanks for being a part of this broadcast tonight on the Bearcats Sports Radio Network, 57-44. Sam Houston men's basketball trying to find some life here and put a stop to this Longhorn team, ranked number 7 of the nation. 7 of their last 9 shots going in the second half. The Bearcats shooting 40%, 6 of 15, but it's been blistering hot for the Longhorns. 7 of 11 shooting 64%, 57% overall. Texas, though, with 15 turnovers, only 10 for Sam Houston. The Bearcats have scored 24 in the paint. They have limited the Horns to only 14 down there inside that paint. 10 second-chance points for the Bearcats compared to 5 for Texas, but 8 fast-break points and 19 off the bench for the Horns. Really, it's just been the shooting tonight that is giving Texas this advantage. We'll get back into action here. Sam Houston inbounding as Jaden Ray from right to left on the right wing. 2 high screens, working through double of them up to the top of the 3-point line. He'll put it into his right hand, floats it down low to Savion Flagg near the right baseline. Turnaround jumper too strong off the back of the glass. The ball bounced around. Nicholas trying to haul into it, but it goes right into the hands of Ramey. Ramey goes over to Carr. Carr from the right side as Jaron Cook got a hand on it. And here is Timmy Allen. Allen went up for it, and see who this foul is called on.
Personal foul number 10, Damon Nicholas.
It's called on Damon Nicholas, his first personal on the 17 foul. So now Texas is in the bonus. They'll shoot free throws the rest of this, 8:46. As DeMarcus Lampley and Javion May checking back into the game, Jaron Cook will head over to the bench, and Savion Flagg joining him as well. So a 1-1 here for Allen. They said he was not in the act of shooting. He was wanting that one in the act, but he didn't get it. So Allen here with a 1-1. Allen, a 70% free throw shooter entering this contest. He'll bend his knees, right-handed free throw on the way, and it rolls in and good. Allen with 8 points tonight, 1 of 4 from the field in 26 minutes. Jones has 14, Carr has 13, and Ramey has 12. They're all on the court right now alongside Askew. Here's the next free throw. This one, no good. But the rebound right there by Andrew Jones as he had position on it. Javion May guarding him, back over to Carr on the right wing. Carr guarded by Ray. Trying to drive inside the paint. He'll find Ramey at the top with 9 seconds on the shot clock. Back over to Allen on the right wing from the right elbow. Pass over to Carr, down to 4. He's got to shoot. Hand in his face from Ray, and somehow he high arcs that one in. That was good defense by Jaden Ray, but that 3 was even better as he made it rain from high atop the ceiling here at Gregory Gymnasium. 61-44, Longhorns pulling away. The Bearcats have not scored in over 2:30, and the Horns on a 9-0 run during the last 2 minutes. Here's DeMarcus Lampley. He'll step back from the top of the 3 over to Nicholas. Nicholas trying to work inside right baseline. He'll flip this one up. He's fouled. And Bearcats will go to the line here shooting 2. A foul was on Andrew Jones, his second personal. And 16 fouls for Texas. Should have been in the act of shooting, though, so Nichols will go to the line here to shoot 2 for Sam Houston. Damon Nicholas Jr., the 6'4", freshman guard, 4 of 5 from the free throw line in 6 games this season. And his first time at the charity stripe here on the left side tonight. Ipe is in there inside the key alongside Javion May. Here is Nicholas as he'll take 2 dribbles. Right hand free throw shot, no good. He's got one more coming up.
Texas substitution, Jace
Febres. Jace Febres back into the game for Andrew Jones. So it is Allen, Carr, Ramey, Askew, and Febres for Texas. Lampley, Nicholas, May, Ipe, and Ray for Sam Houston. Here's Nicholas trying to make the second one on its way. This one is good. So that'll finally put a stop to the 9-0 run, but Sam Houston has still not made a basket from the field in almost 3 minutes. 61-45, 7:57 to go here in the second half. Askew over to Carr on the right side, back over to Askew right wing. As he is guarded by Lampley, trying to drive inside from the left elbow. Pass goes back out to Carr, guarded by Ray. High screen here, Allen. Driving inside is Carr. Carr off the right side, no good. Here come the Bearcats on the far side. Jaden Ray with the ball in his left hand, working the dribble across center court. at the top of the left Longhorn logo that's resting out there. Ray wants to go inside. Turn on the speed, baby. This one no good. The rebound, May. The putback good by Javion May. Jaden Ray had the speed, could not complete the shot, but Jaden Ray had it, could not complete it. Javion May there to clean it up. 61-47. Now we'll end over 3 minutes and 30 seconds of no field goals for the Cats. Here's the Horns with the lead, 7:10 to go. Carr on the right side from the free throw line. Pass over here, right wing three. This one rolls in and out for Febles. And oh my goodness, it doesn't roll out. It took a high bounce and rolled back in. So Febles got the little home court rim as that one dropped in on a second or third bounce. 64-47, Bearcats trailing. Here's Ray from the left wing. He'll pick up his dribble, now rotates over the left wing. Finds Tristan Ipe up top. Ipe. Pass back over to Ray on the left wing with 9 on the shot clock. Rotates over to Nicholas from the baseline. Throws this one over to Ipe, and it bounces, goes out of bounds. Turnover by Sam Houston. And that ball will go right back to Texas, leading 64-47. Their largest lead at 17 with 6:34 to go here in Austin. We'll step aside for 2 minutes on a media timeout. Don't go anywhere, friends. Sam Houston men's basketball on the Bearcat Sports Radio Network from Ben Wagner continues in a moment.
Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest. Conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville, the Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep, along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
The Bearcat Pavilion at Bauer Stadium is a new and exciting place to enjoy Bearcat football. Fans will find Smokin' Sammy's Barbecue, sodas, beer and wine, and a number of other food options from atop the southwest corner overlooking all of the action at Bauer Stadium. Bearcat Pavilion can be reserved on game days for pregame and or postgame private functions and may also be reserved for private events throughout the year. For more information about Bearcat Pavilion at Bauer Stadium, call 936-294-2701.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Welcome back, friends. A pleasant good Monday evening to you. 64-47, the Longhorns over your Sam Houston men's basketball team with 6:34 remaining here. A very unique setup tonight at the Gregory Gymnasium. This was the home for the Longhorns from 1930 to 1977 before the Irwin Center was built. The Irwin Center has served the city of Austin well and the university, but it too has run its course as the new Moody Arena being built. That's where Texas will play basketball, seating over 10,000. That will start next season. They're expecting that to be completed in the spring. Sam Houston, though, a lot of great things happening for the university in Huntsville. Moving to the FBS, their one and only year in the Western Athletic Conference. They will join Conference USA next season. And in football, we'll make that transition to FBS. Well, a lot of great things happening. 22,000 students. I've heard rumors or estimates that it could be up to 30 to 35,000 in the next 10 years. And it really keeps a lot going for folks in the state of Texas that would like to remain in the state after they graduate high school. We'll get back into action here as the Horns have it inbounding. The left side is askew over to Carr on the far side. Jaden Ray with the defense in the backcourt. But Carr, though, brings it into the front court on the near side from left to right. Trying to work through Jaden Ray. Ray, great defense here. And, well, maybe just a little too much. He was using his body there and bumped into Carr. So Jaden Ray with his second personal. 18 fouls for the Bearcats. And a 1-1 coming up here for Marcus Carr, the 6'1 senior guard for the Horns. 5 of 9 entering tonight, 56% from a free throw line. He has played in 5 games, averages 6 points a game. Here's the first one on the front end is good. He'll have one more coming up. As the Horns continue to extend their largest lead, now at 18, 65-47 with 6:20 to go here in Austin. Carr's next free throw on the way. This one good as well, makes both of them. Andrew Jones checking back into the ballgame. And Marcus Carr back over to the sideline. So it is Allen Jones, Ramey Askew, and Frevers on the court for Texas. And for your Bearcats, it's Flagg, Lampley, May, Ipe, and Ray. So back to the starters here. As Ray has it on the right wing, guarded by Askew. Retreats back up near center court. Now goes down to Ipe from the left elbow. Hand off to Lampley. Lampley, right-handed dribble to Ray. Ray guarded by Allen. High screen, Flagg, Ray over the top of the three. He'll find Lampley. Lampley trying to work inside, splitting through defenders, picks up his dribble, throws this one up. No good, but he's fouled. And DeMarcus Lampley will go to the free throw line. 2 free throws coming up. As the foul called there on Jace Febris. That is his second. And 17 fouls for the Horns. So the Bearcats will shoot free throws the rest of this 5:55. That one in the act of shooting, though, will send Lampley to the line for 2. DeMarcus Lampley, 3 points only in this game. 1 of 7. 1 of 6 from three-point land. He's played in 23 minutes. Right-handed free throw shot on the way. Good for Lampley. Got to get his confidence built up. He is a shooter. It's a young man that provides a spark to this team, but he's been a little quiet this season so far. Still the second leading scorer, averaging 11 points per game. Bearcats, one more free throw coming up here for Lampley, 66-48. A little bit of time taken here. Carr will check back into the game for the Horns as Febris over to the bench. Lampley made the first free throw just moments ago. He'll have one more here with 5:55 to go in the game. His team trailing 66-48. He'll take a deep breath. Students making noise on that left side, just in front of the stage. There's a right-handed free throw. This one on the way, good for Lampley as he nails both of them. 66-49, Horns on the inbound. They turn it over. And Sam Houston will get it right back. It was a little hard pass thrown into Marcus Carr, and he went out of bounds, so Sam Houston will get it right back here. For Texas, turning it over. Javion May to inbound in front of students, yelling in his face. With their shirts off, Texas written across their chest in paint. Here's Ipe, up top to Savion Flagg from the left wing. Tries to work inside, throws this one up. No foul was called as he hit the deck, and the Horns with the rebound. Here comes Marcus Carr. Savion Flagg reaches in on him, and there's the foul on, or beg your pardon, Javion May, and there's the foul on Javion May. Savion Flagg having a hard time getting up here on the left side. And boy, that is huge for Sam Houston. That's your leading scorer, as Coach Jason Hooten will immediately run over and take a look at him. Trainers over there also taking a look at Savion Flagg. We'll step aside. We'll take a 30-second break. 66-49, 5:39 to go here in the game. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcat Sports Radio Network.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
Savion Flagg, still some attention being catered to him over there, and he will hop up here. Gingerly gets up, and that will probably do it for Savion Flagg. Hopefully everything okay with him as he is hobbling on that left leg. And that's your leading scorer. That is a huge blow to this Sam Houston team. Savion Flagg has been the grace for this Bearcat squad through 6 games this season, as Kuba Krawowski will step up to him as well, and the attention to Savion Flagg on the bench. Damon Nicholas Jr. back out on the court alongside Dante Powers. Free throws coming up here for Marcus Carr. 1 and 1 coming up here for Carr. 66-49, Texas leading, 5:39 to go here in this ball game. As Carr to the line to shoot the 1 and 1. 18 points, 6 of 11 from the field. Makes the first free throw. He's now 3 for 3. Remains perfect at that charity stripe. One more here for Carr as he'll bend his knees. Right-handed free throw. This one rattles out. No good. And Ipe with the rebound off the missed free throw. Over to Dante Powers on the far side from right to left, right-handed dribble guarded by Askew. On that right wing now is Powers. He's been quiet here tonight from the baseline. Picks up his dribble, swings it down to Ipe, and it's turned over. Here comes Askew, quickly over to Ramey on the right side. He slips down there, and Javion May trying to pick it up. Lampley down there as well. And a timeout called by Texas. A lot of moisture down on that court, and thankfully Ramey hopped right back up. You do not want to see any of these kiddos get hurt. Ramey took a deep dive, but he hopped right back up. That's good for Texas. And that will take us to a timeout. Texas calls it for 30 seconds. We'll be back from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
I got it here from Austin, Texas, Gregory Gymnasium. I'm Rob Hipp, Sam Houston men's basketball trailing University of Texas Longhorns 67-49, 5:16 to go. And both squads right now pretty much on track with their scoring offense and defense. Sam Houston averages close to 70 a game. Actually, they're way below their side. They only have 49 in this game. They average close to 70. As the Horns will inbound, here's a three-point from the corner for Carr. It won't fall, tipping up in the air, and Allen, boy, he wins that battle against two Bearcats, hauling in the offensive rebound. Javion May guarding him. Allen from the baseline, spin inside, 360 degrees like a top, and lays it up off the left side of the glass. 20-point Longhorn advantage, 4:50 to go, 69-49. Dante Powers has it on the left side, behind the back dribble at the top of the three. Still has it, now picks it up. Drop pass over to the right wing, DeMarcus Lampley calling for Ipe on a screen. Here's a three for Lampley, that one well long. The air conditioner turned on and blew it away from the rim. Horns bring it into the front court. Carr has it on the near side from left to right. It's a 20-point Longhorn advantage, 4:28 to go here in Austin. Carr guarded by Dante Powers, picks up the dribble, swing pass off the right Hipp down to Allen. Near the right wing, trying to drive inside. Oh, Ipe hauls it away, strips it. Here's Nicholas Jr. to the left side. Good after the strip by Tristan Ipe. So a little defense leading to offense for Sam Houston. 4 minutes to go, 69-51. Bearcats trailing Longhorns in the driver's seat here tonight on their home court. In this first game for men's basketball at Gregory Gymnasium since 1977. Allen has it at the top of the three. Ipe guarding him. He'll find Askew from the left corner. Now left wing. Pass goes over to Ramey. Ramey zings this one over to the right corner to Allen. And Allen lunges forward and a foul here on Ipe. Ipe trying to reach in a little bit too much, and that'll take us to a media timeout. We'll be back in 2 minutes from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Sam Houston Bearcats are national champions. Don't miss the excitement of Bearcat football. Season tickets and single game seats still available. Call the Bearcat Ticket Office at 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearcats.com/tickets.
Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated is a family-owned, full-service business based in Huntsville, Texas for over 20 years. They do business cards, decals, yard signs, banners, and billboards to name a few. They can design and fabricate electrical signs to fit your business needs. Busted signs and lights? Their 45-foot bucket truck and in-house electrician can service you. They are located at 625 Highway 190 East. Give them a call at 936-435-9966. Artex Signs and Lighting Incorporated looks forward to serving you.
You might know that State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has great service. She is your good neighbor after all. Did you know State Farm has surprisingly great rates too? Yep, along with good neighbor service, State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes has surprisingly great rates for everyone in Huntsville and Walker County. So call State Farm agent Diana K. Barnes at 936-295-2686 for your surprisingly great rates today. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
69-51 here in Austin, Texas. Sam Houston men's basketball trailing the Longhorns with 3:41 remaining in this one. Earlier, Savion Flagg went down pretty hard for a few moments on his right leg, but he appears to be okay, and he is actually back, as it stands right now, back into the ball game. So that is very good if you're a Bearcat fan. Never want to see any of these young guys hurt on any side of the court, especially for Sam Houston. Savion Flagg, who's the leading scorer for this team, averaging almost 20 points a game, and he is back out there on the court as we come out of the media timeout. So good news for the Bearcats and for Savion Flagg. 69-51, again, that score remains. I want to thank everybody for joining us here tonight on the Bearcat Sports Radio Network. Sam Houston played tough through the first half at halftime, trailing 38-28. Bearcats got it back to within two in the second half, but then the Longhorns pulled away. And it's been all horns here over the last 7 minutes or so. Sam Houston's shooting has also dried up. They're only shooting 8 of 21 in the second half, 38%. They are 40 overall, 20 of 50. They've actually put up 9 more shots than the Horns. And so if Sam Houston could just find a way to shoot the ball a little bit better, this is a team that can compete with any team on any given night. So here's Allen at the line for UT. First free throw on the way for that young man is good at the bottom of the net. Allen now with 11 points, 7 of 9 from the charity stripe here tonight. Allen, Jones, Carr, Ramey, Askew on the court for Texas. As he'll take a couple of dribbles, bends his knees, right-handed free throw on the way. This one good as well as he rattled it home. It's back to the largest advantage for Texas, 71-51 by 20, with 3:37 to go here at the Greg. Jaden Ray has it, left-handed dribble over to the left side of the left wing. Drop pass over to Javion May, back to Jaden Ray. Here's Ipe now. Ipe trying to go inside, offensive foul, Tristan Ipe. He's got 5, he'll foul out. So Tristan Ipe fouls out of the ball game with 5 fouls, 10 team fouls now. And that's tough for Tristan Ipe. Ipe averages 3 fouls per game, and now he will foul out. Kian Scroggins checks back into the game for the Bearcats, as Timmy Allen set to inbound here, way on the left side of the court for the Horns. Allen having a little friendly discussion with the official. He's down there smiling. Here's the pass to Jones. Back over to Allen in the backcourt from left to right. Allen ball in his right hand. Kian Scroggins guarding him at the top. Over to Carr on the right wing. Jaden Ray down there on him. Here's the pass over to Jones. Jones almost loses the handle. Javion Mays guarding him on the right baseline. Spins around, ball poked away, but it goes right to Allen. He throws up a shot. And a foul here. We'll see if it's on Sam Houston.
Offensive foul.
No, it's an offensive foul. So Timmy Allen with a third personal foul. 8 team fouls for the Horns. And Sam Houston took the offensive charge. 71-51, 3:06 to go here in Austin. Bearcats trailing. Allen will head back over to the bench. Checking in for him is Christian Bishop, the 6'7" senior forward. They're still wiping up a little bit of sweat down in the semicircle on the right side under the right rim. Savion Flagg to inbound here for the Bearcats. He does so to Jaden Ray in the backcourt. Ray, Carr back there in the backcourt with him as Ray will bring it into the front court now on the near side from right to left. Left-handed dribble, cross back over to the right side. Up top to the three, right wing, drop pass goes to Lampley. Lampley working on a skew to the right wing. Over the head pass to Javion May. May have been looking for Scroggins. May wasn't expecting the ball poke from behind, but it goes right to Lampley. 10 on the shot clock. Ray has it right wing. Down to 7. Ray inside the paint. Over to Lampley. Left wing 3. Yes! Rattle it home and turn on the lights for DeMarcus Lampley from downtown. 71-54. Horns up front. 2:29 to go. As Ramey has it from left to right, Savion Flagg guarding him way up top near the three-point line. The left wing down to Jones. Jones zings this one up top over to Ramey. Ramey, quick right-handed pass to Askew for 3. This one rolls in and out. Kian Scroggins with the high rebound. Chest pass goes to Lampley, back to Jaden Ray. Ray on the near side from right to left. He'll go across a high Kian Scroggins screen. Over to Lampley, left corner 3. Back-to-back threes, and DeMarcus Lampley coming alive here for the Bearcats. Mentioned earlier, Lampley makes 10 three-pointers from multiple spots during practice. He will not move until he's made 10 in each spot. And finally, a little bit of life here for Lampley. It's 71-57, 1:40 to go. The Horns have it back on the right side, and a foul here by Kian Scroggins on Christian Bishop. Timeout called by Texas. We'll take 30 seconds with them. 71-57, Bearcats trailing. We'll be back in 30 seconds from Van Wagner. This is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
Enjoy a great round of golf at the Bearcat Course, formerly Raven Nest. Conveniently located on the southbound side of 45 in Huntsville, the Bearcat Course offers award-winning value with special rates for alumni, faculty, staff, and students of Sam Houston State University. Memberships are available for as low as $139 per month that include unlimited greens fees and cart fees for the whole family. Visit the golf shop to get fitted for equipment and for the full stock of Sam Houston State University logoed men's and women's apparel. Let's play golf at the all-new Bearcat Course in Huntsville.
Welcome back, friends. Rob Hipp here. Thanks for joining us from Gregory Gymnasium on the campus of the University of Texas. 71-57, Sam Houston men's basketball trailing the Horns with 1:40 to go here in the ballgame. With a 20-point advantage earlier for UT, but the Bearcats on a 6-0 run over the last minute, making three of their last three shots. The Horns have not scored in over 2 minutes, and here come the Bearcats. From right to left, inbounding. Jaden Ray has it. Over to Savion Flagg. No, Ray's going to keep it here. Quickly over to Javion May. Back to Ray. Ray using his right arm, trying to find separation on a skew. He'll go from the left baseline. Picks up his dribble. Here's Lampley. Three threes in a row. Rattles in and out. No good. Boy, that one was almost down there for DeMarcus Lampley as he was hot on the previous two threes. That one wouldn't fall. And here come the Horns. It is Carr on the right side. Javion May trying to poke it away from him. Carr using his left arm, trying to make separation. Way out near the half-court line. 14 on the shot clock. Askew has it on the right wing. Ray guarding him. Here's a chest pass. Goes over to Ramey. Way up top to the three to Allen, who checked back in on the right wing. Pass back to Askew. Askew rotates over. Three on the clock. Bounce pass goes down low. And here's a shot and one for Ramey. Coach Hooten was wanting a carry. Didn't get the call. And Ramey going to the line here. After the assist by Askew and one. That foul is on Kian Scroggins, his second personal. Bearcats already well over the limit, so an and one free throw coming up here for Ramey regardless. Ramey for the Horns on the right side to shoot the free throw. His first time at the foul line here tonight. Ramey right-handed shot on the way. Rattles in and out, no good. Rebound goes to DeMarcus Lampley. Here come the Cats. 46 seconds to go, 73-57. Jaden Ray loses the handle, picks it back up. Savion Flagg to Ray from the left corner. Askew on him. Ray, ball's knocked out of bounds by Askew, and it goes off of Jaden Ray. As Askew very happy with his play, as he should be, yelling out, let's go. 5 second differential, so the Horns have it with 35.9 to go. 73-57. Javon Grant will check into the game for the first time. The 5'11 freshman guard for Sam Houston for Jaden Ray. Grant, Flagg, Lampley, May, and Powers out there for the catch. Jones askew. Lacone, Tyson, and Benson for the Horns. Longhorns got to bring it into the front court. Here's Askew with DeMarcus Lampley guarding him. Down to 27 seconds. Over to Lacone. Lacone on the left wing, guarded by Grant. Trying to work inside here. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Floats one up, and this one an air ball, and it goes right into the hands of Javion May. Over to Powers on the far side from right to left. He loses the handle. It's a turnover. Lacone has it. And the Horns will time it out here as Texas victorious 73-57 here tonight in Austin. We'll step aside and take a break from Ben Wagner. This is American Sports Radio Network.
Ticket Smarter is glad we are back to holding live events. If you are looking to buy tickets to the best sports, concerts, and theater events, all at the very best price, look no further than TicketSmarter.com or on the app. Buying tickets at Ticket Smarter will help support children in need. For every ticket transaction on Ticket Smarter, $1 will be donated to a children's charity. Ticket Smarter is proud to be the official ticketing partner of Bearcat Athletics. Ticket Smarter, a smarter way to buy tickets.
Need service work on your vehicle? Then drop on by Wiesner Huntsville and meet the new service and shop managers to see what better customer service feels like. Meet their GM factory-trained technicians who are skilled with state-of-the-art factory diagnostic equipment. Wiesner service hours Monday through Saturday are convenient and local shuttle service is readily available. Experience the service difference at Wiesner Huntsville.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Season tickets are on sale for 2021-22 basketball season. Season tickets start as low as $99. One price gets you both men's and women's Bearcat basketball. Call 936-294-1729 or go online at gobearcats.com/tickets to secure your seat today.
Curious about what real estate agents enjoy the most? It's about reminding our clients that dreams really do come true. RE/MAX is the number one real estate company nationwide. RE/MAX Prime Properties is a locally owned family business in Huntsville. Need a realtor knowledgeable in our area? Call one of our experienced agents and let us guide you home. RE/MAX Prime Properties is located at 1215 Financial Plaza, Huntsville, Texas, and is a proud partner of SHSU Athletics. Eat 'em up, cats.
101.7 KSAM and the Bearcat Sports Network present the Bearcat Basketball Postgame Show. Now for an in-depth analysis of tonight's game, let's return courtside with Rob Hipp.
73-57, your final tonight, a seventh-ranked Texas Longhorns defeat your Bearcats. Here for an historic matchup tonight at an historic, well, a matchup tonight at the historic venue. Gregory Gymnasium. Been a fun one tonight. Sam Houston held tough through about two-thirds of this game, but the Longhorns just proved too much, and the hot shooting for Texas propelled them into this ballgame. Sam Houston's shooting woes continue. We'll see if they can pick things up. But every game, Sam Houston learning a little bit more. One area they just got to improve on really is shooting and making their free throws. If Sam Houston could shoot a little bit better, they would still be in this ballgame. But as it stands, again, 73-57, your final, as the Bearcats will fall to 2-5 this season, and the Horns will improve to 5-1. Look over team stats here first in this first segment. We will not have an interview with head coach Jason Hooten, as he had to make his way off the court in a post-game press conference with the Longhorn Network. Finals from this game as UT shooting a blistering 54%, 24 of 44 from the field, 11 of 22 from three-point land. They were also 14 of 18 at 78% from the free throw line. They shot 54% in that first half, 55% in the second half. They were a little bit cold from three-point land, 5 of 13 in the first half, but they turned around 6 of 9 in that second half. For your Bearcats, 12 of 29 in the first half, 41%. They shot 10 of 24 to remain around 41% in the second, 41.5% overall, 22 of 53. So they actually put up 9 more shots in the Longhorns and made 2 less. 8 of 21, though, from three-point land, and they were 5 of 9 from the free throw line. Sam Houston, 14 turnovers in this ballgame, 13 for the Horns. Bearcats making 15 points off of 13 turnovers, 29 boards tonight. So Sam Houston does out-rebound the Longhorns, 17 on the defensive side, 12 offensive rebounds. They had a 12 second-chance points, 7 off the bench, 28 down in the paint for Sam Houston. 2 fast-break points, that one blocked by Kuba Kowalski, and 5 steals tonight for Sam Houston. For the Texas Longhorns, they shot 55% again, 24 of 44, 50% from downtown, 11 of 22 from three-point land. They were 78% from the free throw line at 14 of 18, 13 turnovers. They scored 19 points off of 14 Sam Houston turnovers, 27 total rebounds, 20 on the defensive side, 7 on the offensive glass. They had 11 second chance points, 19 off the bench, 18 down in the paint, 8 fast break points, 6 blocks tonight for the Longhorns, and also 7 steals and 16 assists. Sam Houston in this ball game, they led by 5 when it was 10-5. Their last lead was 14-12 with a 13-31 mark. For the Longhorns, they were in control. Their largest lead at 20 at your final score, when it was 71-51. Their last lead, of course, was the end of the game, 73-57. We'll step aside. We'll take another break. And when we come back, the final segment is we'll go over team stats. Stay with us, friends. From Van Wagner, this is the Bearcats Sports Radio Network.
The Bearkat Pavilion at Bowers Stadium is a new and exciting place to enjoy Bearkat football.
Fans will find Smokin' Sammy's Barbecue,
sodas,
beer and wine, and a number of other food options
from atop the southwest corner overlooking all of the action at Bowers Stadium.
Bearkat Pavilion can be reserved on game days for pregame and or postgame private functions
and may also be reserved for private events throughout the year.
For more information about Bearkat Pavilion at Bowers Stadium, call 936-294-2701.
Push Medical Services in Huntsville provides personalized, high-quality health care to meet your individual needs. Health concerns? Need to see a doctor? Heart issues? Need a vaccine? Dr. Henry Burkholder of Push Medical Services strives to address all of your health concerns. Most major health plans are accepted, as well as cash pay. Push Medical Services provides the most affordable care. Don't neglect health concerns. Visit Push Medical Services. For more information, visit pushmedical.org. That's pushmedical.org.
At HEB, we know that game day is about more than the game itself. The taste of victory is unparalleled, but so is the taste of HEB jalapeno poppers hot off the grill. Seeing the best players in their prime is truly something to behold. So is an HEB Prime 1 burger that you grilled to perfection. For low prices on all the things that make game day great and delicious, visit HEB, your official game day headquarters, or use the My HEB app to order curbside and start prepping for game day right away.
Welcome back, friends. Rob Hipp live from Gregory Gymnasium in Austin, Texas, on the campus of the University of Texas, as Sam Houston men's basketball falls tonight. A tough contest for your Bearcats, 57-73. It was all Texas, especially in that final 10 minutes or so into the second half. We'll quickly go over individual stats. The leading scorer tonight for the University of Texas, Carr, had a phenomenal game here for the Longhorns. The 6'1 senior guard, Marcus Carr, finishing up with 19 points, 6 of 12 from the field, 4 of 7 from behind the arc. He was 3 of 4 from the charity stripe, 3 rebounds. He had 4 assists, 1 foul, 2 turnovers, all of that in 34 minutes of play. He was one of 4 players for the Longhorns that were in double digits tonight. Jones as well as Ramey, both with 14 in this game. And then Allen had 12 again for the Longhorns, 11 of 22 from three-point land, shooting 50%. 4 of 7 from downtown for Carr after he only had 2 points in their previous game versus California Baptist. For Sam Houston, they finished with 4 players in double digits as well. The A&M graduate transfer, Savion Flagg, 7 of 16 from the field, 2 of 4 from the three-point line. He was only 0 of 3, though, from the free throw line. That's an area that he struggled entering this ball game, 38% from the charity stripe. He's got to find a way to improve that. 8 rebounds, an assist, a foul, 3 turnovers in 32 minutes. Again, Flagg with 16 points tonight. DeMarcus light him up, Lampley, 3 of 11 from the field. Those 3 baskets came on 3 of 9 from three-point land, a perfect 2 of 2 from the free throw line. Lampley had 2 rebounds, 2 assists, a foul, 2 turnovers in 29 minutes. Again, Lampley with 11. Javion May, he was 5 for 7 from the field, took 1-3 and made it 1 for 1. He had 8 rebounds, 1 assist, 2 fouls, no turnovers tonight for Javion May. In 31 minutes again, Javion May with 11 points. Also in double digits tonight for your Bearcats, Jaden Ray, who's been a spark this season for the Sam Houston team, 3 of 6 from the field, 2 of 2 from downtown, 2 of 2 also from the charity stripe. He had 2 rebounds, 3 assists, 2 fouls, 3 turnovers in 31 minutes. Again, Ray with 10 points. Other Bearcat scorers getting on the board tonight, Nicholas Jr. had 5 in 14 minutes. Kuba Krawowski had 2 lone points in 7 minutes tonight. And then Tristan Ipe, 2 points as well in 22 minutes of play. You add all that up, 22 of 53 in the ball game, 41% tonight for Sam Houston. Well, for the Bearcats, they have now dropped 3 in a row. The Horns back onto the win column at 5-1. Their only loss coming this season to Gonzaga. And coming up next for the Longhorns on Friday, December the 3rd, that will be a home game hosting UT Rio Grande Valley. You can catch that one on the Longhorn Network at 6 p.m. And for your Sam Houston Bearcats, they will have a Thursday night game hosting Shriner, 6:30 p.m. from Johnson Coliseum. Again, help us fill Johnson, encouraging all fans and students come out and support the Bearcats this season. Friends, this broadcast has been authorized under rights granted by Sam Houston to Van Wagner. The accounts and descriptions of this broadcast may not be retransmitted in any form without the express written consent of Van Wagner and Sam Houston Athletics. The executive producers of Sam Houston Basketball is Zach Kaditz. The coordinating producer is Desiree Chambers. And a special thanks, as always, to the Sam Houston Athletic Communications Office, Jason Barfield, Ben Reichard, and Cody Stark. Studio operations at the flagship by KSAM. Nathan Height, our scoreboard engineer tonight. And a big thank you to Carlos Zimmerman running the dials back at the flagship tonight. Again, tune in for the next broadcast on December the 2nd. Again, Sam Houston hosting at Shriner Thursday at 6:30 p.m. We'll have that call again right here in the booth and also, of course, on the Bearcats Sports Radio Network. Friends, I'm Rob Hipp reminding you tonight that we're not strong enough alone to make it on our own. We need each other. Provide a word of encouragement. Lend a hand of support. Somebody out there tonight needs you. Good night and God bless from Austin, Texas.
For any of your shipping, faxing, copying, or notarizing needs, get on down to Pack and Ship. Big or small, they ship it all. Conveniently located right off 45 on Highway 30 next to Hobby Lobby. At Pack and Ship, there are no lines. They have a kind, experienced staff ready to help you. Pack and Ship, happily serving all residents of Walker County and the surrounding areas. Pack and Ship.
Join the Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. For only $35 a year, your membership helps provide scholarship assistance, plus networking, a travel program, discounts on home and auto insurance, car rentals, event tickets, and much more. Connect with your Bearcat pride and spirit by joining the Alumni Association. Go online, alumni.shsu.edu. As a member, you can be a part of something bigger. The Sam Houston State University Alumni Association. Join today.
Listening to Sam Houston State University Bearcat basketball. No portion of this game may be rebroadcast without express written consent from Sam Houston State University, our broadcast partners, or 101.7 KSAM. We are the Bearcat Sports.